Very good morning. Welcome to it. Welcome to you, my brother.
We've made it to Friday.
You've made it. Your first week, my friend. We are so proud of you, dude. Nothing like being thrown in the deep end on live TV, but you have been superb.
Well, you've been amazing. Thank you. You've walked me through the entire thing like it's nothing. It's been a breeze.
Oh, dude, it's so good. You feel like part of the family immediately. So it's so cool to have you here. We've got a great show, a bit of a bittersweet show this morning. We never like starting with this news, but of course, shocking news coming out yesterday.
I mean, we heard yesterday about the passing of SA hip hop star Pro Kid, and so we will be paying tribute to him on the show this morning. Really sad news.
Of course, yeah, we'll send our condolences to his friend, his family, his legion of fans as well. And then, of course, we do get into our usual Friday gig. We've been talking about all sorts of designer things lately, and I'm not talking about clothes, I'm talking about human lungs that are going to be grown in a lab. Now you can design your own baby, and normally I would shake my head thinking that it's completely untrue, but I've learned that most of these things are possible
now. Do actually
happen. So we're going to get a tech update this morning and fill you in on that. And then we've got Rocco de Villiers in the house, the incomparable, the one and only. He's here to perform for you and also fill us in on what he's been up to.
Also, on design news, Gert-Johan Coetzee has been working really hard. You can't stop the man. Yep. He's come out with a new range or line for kids. His first one ever. That's going to be exciting to find out about.
It's going to be so exclusive. Just wait for Instagram to explode. But it is going to be an amazing show. And of course, the English Premier League also kickstarts. So we're going to get your predictions. But let's start the day officially with the gorgeous Zoe and our news headlines.
Oh, thank you, gentlemen, and a very good morning to you at home. Starting with your national news, President Cyril Ramaphosa has announced that a national gender summit will be held on 31 August to deal with issues of gender-based violence. Ramaphosa delivered the keynote address at the National Women's Day celebrations in Paarl yesterday morning. He called for a moment's silence to remember women who had been brutalized and exploited. He told the thousands of attendees at the event in Bakweni in Paarl that men should hang their heads in shame. He said women should feel protected whether they are in the streets, on village pathways, at work, or just going about their daily lives. Meanwhile, in Johannesburg later yesterday, President Ramaphosa said that South African government should not allow land grabs and anarchy in the process of finding a solution for the land issue. He was speaking at a conference attended by investors who had expressed an interest in the SA government's efforts to attract new foreign direct investment of $100 million over the next 5 years. Ramaphosa said the land issue will be addressed in such a way that the outcome is good for all in SA. And moving to news abroad, some dozen writers from African and Middle East countries hoping to attend a book festival in Scotland this weekend have had their visa applications refused, the event organizers say. And Edinburgh International Book Festival director Nick Barley said that although he realizes it is systematic, it is a very serious matter. And the festival organizers haven't named the authors in question. At least last month's WOMAD festival, at least three African acts on the bill were unable to perform due to visa complications with British immigration. And finally, Argentina's senators yesterday voted against legalizing abortion in the homeland of Pope Francis, dashing the hopes of women's rights groups after a bill was approved by legislature's lower house some months earlier. The vote was 38 against, 31 in favor, with two abstentions, capped a marathon session that began the day before and stretched into the early hours of yesterday. The vote followed a referendum in Ireland, another traditionally Catholic country, in May that paved the way to legislate for the termination of fetuses. That's where I leave your news for this morning. We'll touch on your headlines in half an hour, but let's take a first look at your sport with Graham.
Let's kick it off with cricket ahead of a busy bumper weekend. Proteas tour of Sri Lanka gets set to conclude, and the Proteas tour of Sri Lanka, of course, will round off with that once-off T20 next Tuesday, and that as Sri Lankan captain Dinesh Chandimal is back after serving as international ban for refusing to take the field during their test series against the West Indies recently, relating to accusations of ball tampering. He's in the 15-man squad for the shortest format, but not for Sunday's final ODI. The series at 3-1, the Proteas will again be led by Quinton de Kock in the absence of injured Faf du Plessis before JP Germany steps in to the captaincy role on Tuesday. Then on the footballing front locally, ahead of a brief break for the weekend, last night's only fixture in the PSL gave us four goals as Highlands Park drew 2-2 with Black Leopards. Lucky boy McQuenna got Highlands off the mark from range in a night that really tested Leopards' diminutive shot stopper Roshidzwa Muleka. While Bevan Fransman was pretty solid marshalling the defence at the back, Highlands did let Leopards back in the game in the second. So the league resumes next Tuesday at 7:30 with a spirited Baraka up against, must be said, rather tentative Chiefs in this early stages of the season. Then just in time to get us excited, the return of European football. UEFA released their shortlist for the cream of the crop of last season. So Liverpool's Mo Salah expectedly joins the usual suspects, Ronaldo and Messi, for best forward. Last year's winner, now in Italy, of course, Ronaldo is a shoo-in with his 15 goals for the reigning European champions. Salah had a remarkable run to the finals with 10 goals, Messi in there with 6. Best defender sees Marcelo up against Sergio Ramos and Rafael Varane. And in the midfield, Kevin De Bruyne features alongside Real's duo of Toni Kroos and Luka Modric. The winners will be announced in Monaco on the 30th of August at the group stage draw. And then finally, lots of excitement ahead of the start of the English Premier League. And albeit quieter than normal, in yesterday's Premier League transfer deadline, moved forward to the day before today's season start for the first time. The move of the day had to be Colombian World Cup star Yerry Mina signing to Everton from Barcelona. The top he spent a lot, also landing Barca's Andre Gomes and Brazilian winger Bernard. But I think the most publicised disappointment, Jose Mourinho unable to find a credible centre-back. We'll see if there are any notable holes as Man United get the league underway at Old Trafford tonight at 9 o'clock up against Leicester City. And of course, we're going to open the lines for your Premier League predictions this morning. 021-430-9881. You better have it on speed dial.
Well, let's get your morning underway by taking a first look at your temperatures for today. And it's a cold start for most parts of the country, and the Eastern Cape can expect some much needed rain. East London, windy conditions, in fact, a west-southwesterly wind of 32 kilometers an hour expected for today. Looking at those temperatures, Polokwane, your minimum for today is 8, your maximum 24. Mbombela, 11 with a high of 28. Pretoria, 4, reaching a high of 20. Johannesburg, 1 with a high of 18. Partly cloudy conditions in Mahikeng, -1 with a high of 17. Klerksdorp starting off on 0, reaching a high of 17. Kimberley 0, reaching a high of 13. Partly cloudy conditions in Bloemfontein with a cool start of -4 and a maximum of 12 for today. Richards Bay 11, 22. Pietermaritzburg 4 with a high of 20. Durban 14, reaching a high of 22. And Mthatha a low of 5, a high of 14. Wind is expected for East London today. Strong winds of a west-southwesterly wind of 32 kilometers an hour, reaching a high of 14. And rain is expected for Craddock, a low of -1 and a high of 11. Port Elizabeth 7-14, George 6 with a high of 13, Sutherland starting off on a cool -2 with a high of 8, Cape Town 6 with a high of 16, Worcester 2 reaching a high of 14, Springbok 3 with a high of 12, and Upington -1 with a maximum of 15 degrees Celsius. That's where I leave your weather for this morning. I'll have another update for you in half an hour.
Okay, so we all know that we live in a world that is constantly changing and life seems to be getting faster by the day. So as we welcome today the 10th of August, we take a look at what happened in history on this day, the 10th of August.
And it was quite a historic day, many, many years ago. So on this day in 1793, the Musée du Louvre, or Louvre Museum, opened up in Paris. It's one of the most famous, of course, landmarks in all of the world. If you're going to go to Paris, you have to go to the Louvre. Mm. It displays the Mona Lisa and is one of the most visited, or was one of the most visited places in 2017, seeing some 8 million feet go through
incredible.
That door.
Also, so incredible. Just also have to note, being the Beyonce fan that I am, that that's where they shot the music video for their latest hit, her and Jay-Z.
But oh,
also,
yes.
Yeah, no, it's amazing. Also, on this day in 1960, the Alfred Hitchcock horror film Psycho premieres in Los Angeles to box office and critical acclaim. Considered an all-time great film, everybody loves it. It set a new level of what kind of content was seen as acceptable in movies.
Yeah, is that where we started to get to know the soundtrack? Clee, 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 clee,
clee, clee, clee, clee. That's a more accurate description. It says it all.
And then also on this day, August 10th, 1990, the Magellan space probe launched by NASA reached the planet Venus after a 4-year and 2-month long trip.
That's a long way to get there. Yeah, that is quite the story. Well, that's our bite-sized dose of history for this morning. Seize the day and make it one for the books.
Well, we are taking a quick break on your Feel Good Breakfast show. When we get back, we're going to get to know our performer, Rocco de Villiers, a little bit better. And I'm loving the orange. Is it croissant?
Croissant.
There we go. I'm loving it.
What don't we know about Rocco, man? He's been here so many times. We're looking forward to that then. Ashfak Mohamed is here. I think Kat, myself, and Ash are all a little bit too excited about the start of the Premier League. It's back, baby. We're going to take your calls 021-430-9081. What are your predictions? We'll see you after the break.
Welcome back to your Feel Good Breakfast show, the Expresso show. Now, it's a Friday, but it's also World Lion Day. I mean, this week clearly has been the week of celebrating all the big cats. It was Cat Day the other day, and today we celebrate the lion. We posted on our social media, it's World Lion Day. We have so many incredible animals in our country, and we wanted to find out from you which of the most incredible big five is your favorite. And some of your comments have been coming through here. Nokolo Magazi says, mine is the lion because I'm a Leo. I was born in August. Hey, shout out to all the Leos, as well as one coming through from Christopher saying, good morning, Expresso team. My favorite animal is the king of the jungle, the lion. Good morning, fam. Mine is an elephant because my surname is Ndlovu. That's from Innocent. Well, why don't you let us know? Head off to our Facebook page and Twitter, hashtag Expresso Show, and let us know what your favorite animal of the big five is.
Ah, take a deep breath. It is back. The English Premier League is here. New managers, new players. Not as many as you'd expect during a transfer deadline, but of course that deadline shifted to the day before the actual start of the English Premier League. A lot of pressure, obviously. The World Cup vaunting those prices just a little bit. But of course, he's not on our team officially. We've got him on loan, but we've got him for this season. Yeah. Ash, welcome back, man. Good to have you here. I know you are feeling particularly excited about this. This is a fresh season.
I feel like it is a fresh new start for the Gunners. It feels like we've got a whole new look, not just a new kit, new manager in place, a couple of new faces as well. But let's take a look at some of the top teams that one would expect to perform well all throughout the English Premier League, starting off with the Gunners. Unai Emery, who's...
Former PSG manager, Graham, and he's brought in a whole new culture at Arsenal. Of course, after 22 years of Monsieur Arsène Wenger, it's going to change totally, and he wants him to play more attacking game, more pressing game. He's very technical, so the guys are getting homework and things like that, whereas with Arsène was just, you know, laissez-faire, just play football, you know.
Express yourself.
So now Emery's going to try and bring new things in there.
Speaking of expressing yourself, one of the clicks that's going to need to happen with Emery is Mesut Ozil. Do you think he has gotten over Germany's soul-crushing defeat? Looking at his social media posts, he seems to be in a pretty good mood.
Yeah, pre-season, they've got a good vibe going at the moment. He was captain in the pre-season, so probably for the season as well. So that's a good move to get him going.
Yeah, do you think that's a move... done psychologically to give him that platform.
I think just
and he needs it, especially
you know?
After the bashing he got from the German media, given the whole Turkish thing. It was ridiculous. But here he is. I think it's a big benefit for Arsenal that he's now coming in. Sans the responsibilities of a national. had to work that in there. But I think he's going to be quite a vital man for the season.
Maurizio Sarri, a man with unbelievable pressure on his shoulders, not just during this transfer window, if you think about Thibaut Courtois disappearing to Real 2 days before the deadline end.
Yeah.
What is going on in Chelsea?
At least you got a new keeper, and let's get the name right. Keeper Aritha Balaga.
Aritha Balaga. You got to say it with
from
with
Athletic Bilbao in Spain.
This commentator's going to have fun.
So they sorted that out. But he had a late start, Sarri, because he was only confirmed in mid-July. So that's a bit of a challenge. And although he did well, Napoli hasn't really won a lot of trophies. And of course, we know Chelsea is all about trophies. You can win the league. 6 months later, you're out.
Was he responsible for Jorginho coming across?
Yes, of course. Yeah, Jorginho will be the main guy. I think he'll build the team around that. Some new ideas as well from Sarri, so let's see what they can do.
So who are they expecting to score goals now at Chelsea? Is it going to be Giroud, Hazard,
Alvaro Morata again in pre-season. He hasn't performed. Giroud, we know what happened at the World Cup. Good target, man, but you're not going to get goals out of the guys.
I mean, Mbappe is still dreaming about that magical pass he made that he just couldn't bury.
Of course,
shots fired, guys. Shots fired. So when we look at Liverpool, so close yet so far away last season, they are probably the biggest spenders in the transfer window.
Yeah, look, with the goalkeeper world record there, Alisson Becker from Brazil coming in. You know, a lot of people's sort of contenders for the title this time around, although I feel City's still a very strong squad. But yeah, Klopp has well, except for perhaps another defender. You know, he did bring in Virgil van Dijk last season, but perhaps another one there. Attacking force, more than enough options. Mohamed Salah, Sadio Mane, all of it.
Salah, the golden boot from last season. I'm going to put it out there to the Liverpool Supporters Club. Give us a call when we open the lines, man. Give us your predictions as well.
Man City, talk about, I mean, a big team that is expected to... I mean, given the past season, you can only expect greatness from them going forward. Talk about their big signing.
Yeah, I think with Man City, their focus is going to be Champions League this season. So perhaps they might miss out on the league, although they have a very strong squad. But, you know, Pep Guardiola, after missing out on the Champions League title last season, I think this time he's got to go for that. You know,
Premier League. Got a pep in his step, and that's... is that how it works? Can you only win one or the other, do you think?
I think if you play in the Premier League, I think it's very difficult to go for both. Yeah. Perhaps if you're in Spain, La Liga, there's not such a lot of competition from the other teams, you know.
So. I was wondering, Riyad Mahrez, is he a good addition to the side? Where do you see him fitting in, especially with the likes of De Bruyne, who are already playing such a pivotal role in midfield?
I think because they have so many campaigns with the Champions League and the Premier League, so they're going to have to mix and match there. You know, you can't have one team playing the whole. So I think Mahrez will get his impact, has a good pre-season as well.
Oh, it's very exciting. We haven't even touched on the other half of that table,
especially
Man United. Well, they didn't buy anyone. But we'll get into that and Spurs. And, of course, open the lines. We want to hear your predictions. 021-4309-881. Who is going to take the English Premier League title this year?
Well, it is now time for our Expresso Rewind game. And Tabiso, you've just had your first week here. So how this game works is we're going to test your knowledge, but we're going to put you up against someone. So while Graham joins us, I'll explain to you the rules of the game. Yeah. So we've got a couple of questions. You need to wait for me to finish the question before you answer.
Okay.
And we will see who gets the most correct. And you get to win the coveted golden monkey.
Okay.
And it's quite competitive.
All right.
So in order for me to...
Where's the buzzer?
There's no buzzer. That's how we do things differently. You have to come up with your own unique sound.
Mm.
So, Graham, do you want to just give Tabiso a demonstration?
Yeah.
That's his sound. So if I hear that, I'll go to Graham first.
All right, cool.
What's yours?
Okay,
quite unique. Okay.
I don't know, we've never
gentlemen,
had a sound like that.
I know.
I don't know how to feel about that, man.
Are you ready? I've got a few questions.
Okay.
I need to complete the question and you're not allowed to look at me. So look to the front.
Okay,
first question. Which song got the majority vote for the first edition of hashtag Tuesday Tunes? Okay, Tabiso.
Mi casa, la vida.
Da 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 da.
Yeah!
Correcto.
Okay.
Is that a favorite of yours, that song?
Well, I enjoyed hearing Kat sing it, you know? I enjoyed Kat doing it.
Okay, 1 point Tabiso, really 0 for Graham. Second question, look to the front.
Okay.
Women's Day commemorates the Women's March to the Union Buildings in which year? Okay, I heard Graham first.
1956.
That is correct. There we go. 1 point each. Good job, gentlemen. Third question.
It's rough out there, but
what is the title of Kate Sidley's book which retells heartwarming stories about Nelson Mandela? Okay, I did hear Tabiso first. You can't get it incorrect.
100 Mandela moments?
That is correct.
Yeah. There we go.
There we go.
That's good, man. Your sound is good, man.
I saw your Insta stories. You're busy reading the book.
Yeah, I am.
How's it going?
I love it. I'm halfway through.
Is it good?
Mm, it's a good
read. Concentrate, man. This
easy.
Is a competition. Okay. Come on.
Last question, gentlemen. The Blisters for Bread walk has been taking place for how many years?
Yeah.
Tabiso?
Two.
No. Graham, take a guess.
Four.
Guys, it's been around for 50 years.
What?
Wow.
It's been around for 50 years.
Have I missed out?
Well, it's taking place at the end of the year, so make sure you're not at the end of the month.
That deserves a few blisters, I think. But that is awesome. Dude, well done, man.
Thank you, well done.
Your induction.
Sure
this is a fun game.
Your induction is complete.
My favorite thing.
We're going to do it every Friday.
Can you pass me the golden monkey?
Who wins now?
I'll do it. I'm going to be magnanimous.
There
we go.
Okay.
Welcome to the family.
Aww.
Thank you so much.
But of course, don't worry, we've got a question for you at home as well. Now, head on over to our social media pages if you know the answer. What is Taryn Lamb's debut solo album called? And if you missed it out, we've got the clip on YouTube. But if you know the answer, head on over to our social media pages. Let us know and use that hashtag Expresso Show.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? We welcome today one of South Africa's music icons, if you will, a legend in his own right, who has now brought out his 14th studio album. I'll tell you all about it shortly, but before we even get to that, ladies and gentlemen, let's give him a round of applause. Rocco de Villiers is in the studio! The ancestral ululation.
Can I just say, I'm so happy that we speak English because whenever I've been here in the past, it was altijd Afrikaans gepraat. And I think South Africa thought that I can't speak English. I'm gonna talk like this. But I can speak English very well. I'm not that good with the past continuous tense though. Do you remember at school? At school, they told us past continuous tense is had been going.
Yeah.
And I could never understand why the teacher said you went, but you still going. So I thought, why don't you call it wenting?
I think we should change this format right now. It should be an English lesson by Rocco. But listen, okay. We're going to have some fun
to get to know you because you work here. You've got a proper cup.
No, Mine. Princess, can you please sort Rocco out?
Mine is McCafe.
What
drink? I feel like Shamisi. I like McCafe.
Oh, wow. It was with Ivers Begin, eh? So we're going to start with a 60-second rapid-fire question.
Yes.
We're going to take 60 seconds on the clock, and then I'm going to ask you questions, and you answer with the first thing that
it's
comes to mind.
It's not general knowledge, like maths
and shit. No, don't worry about it. Okay. Are you ready? Here you go. Start the clock in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. If you had a time machine, would you go to the past or the future?
Oh, definitely the future.
Do you prefer a beach getaway or wild retreat?
Wild retreat.
If you could invite anyone to dinner, who would that be?
What do you call it? Godchild.
Oh, Iron Man or Captain America?
for Iron Man.
Chocolate or vanilla?
Chocolate.
Summer or winter?
I'm winter.
Toilet roll over or under?
Pass.
You can't pass.
Yeah, under.
Would you rather give up piano for a month or be a vegan for a month?
Oh, yeah. Definitely not a vegan.
Pineapple or pizza? Or on your pizza or no?
Oh, yeah. Six.
Movies or books?
Books.
What is the one meal you wish you could have every day?
Salmon and salad.
Sweet or salty?
Salty.
Salty. I think I would have called that one. That was a lot of fun. I feel like we know you a little bit better.
Oh, you think so, but actually...
And so did I. I thought I knew you quite well because we've worked together over a number of years.
Yes, sing so moin.
Danke. But then I also realized that in all the years of knowing you and working with you, I've never seen your legs. And now I get to see them. And it's quite an impressive set of... Have you guys seen Rocco's legs? They're amazing.
I haven't trained. I haven't... What do you call those things? Lunges.
Yeah, yeah.
Because if I lunge, I throw up and then I can't work for 3 days.
What?
No. It's okay. It's okay. This is my eine boerebiene.
This is a kort broek and long kousen type of vibe.
And that's why I'm showing my legs for the first time in my career. Of doing because my new album is called Kortbroek Langkousen.
Tell me about that. I mean, quite a quirky name, obviously, but what are we expecting to hear on Kortbroek Langkousen?
I think we're at a time, Katlego, in our country where everyone, for us to move forward, you've got to make peace with your past and your culture and who you are and what you are. Mm. Because only when you're okay with yourself, you can be okay with other people, and then we could move on. So I, at my age, I decided to make peace with the fact that I'm Afrikaans, that I'm from South Africa, that I like wine gums, that I like Dolly Parton a lot, and that I am what I am, and that I'm this is what I am. If you don't like me, move on. And I grew up with Kortbroek and Langkousen, Longsoften, because I come from the Free State, from a farm, so we have that. But for very long, that has always almost become a swear word in South Africa. You know, it was the sign of the wrong kind of people. Mm. And I thought, at my age, I'm going to make a CD about that, claim that back, but all on my own terms.
All on your own terms. Fantastic. And I can't wait to hear the music from Kortbroek Langkousen. And I'm glad that you've gotten to a point where you are making a statement about that, you know, that you're saying, I am what I am.
Yeah, and no, that's not my line. That's a song.
Yes, I am what I am. But I'm glad you didn't say, I is what I are. You know, that would have been very different.
No, that, only when it's past continuous. I was like I am.
Ladies and gentlemen, Rocco de Villiers in the studio!
I don't know what went on there for the last few minutes. An impossible act to follow, really. So we're going to see Rocco perform a little bit later. We're also going to open the lines 021-430-9881. What are your predictions for the brand new Premier League season?
Exactly. It's a very colourful morning on the Expresso show. We'll also be celebrating and paying tribute to the life of Pro Kid and the colour that he's brought into our lives after the break.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back. You're live with Expresso. And just a moment, Kat and I are going to open the lines to get your predictions on the English Premier League. Who's going to take the title? But right now, let's get you up to speed with those global and local headlines.
Thank you, Graham. Let's quickly touch on those headlines, starting with your national news. President Cyril Ramaphosa has announced that a national gender summit will be held on 31 August to deal with issues of gender-based violence. This was after he was speaking to thousands of people at the National Women's Day celebrations in Paarl yesterday morning. He also said that men should hang their heads in shame. Women should feel protected wherever they are. And in Johannesburg later yesterday, Ramaphosa also said the SA government would not allow land grabs and anarchy in the process of finding a solution for the land issue. He said the land issue would be addressed in such a way that the outcome was good for all in South Africa. Now moving to news abroad, some dozen writers from African and Middle East countries hoping to attend a book festival in Scotland this weekend have had their visa applications refused at last month's WOMAD festival. At least three African acts on the bill were unable to perform, and that's due to visa complications with British immigration. And Argentina's senators yesterday voted against legalization of abortion in the homeland of Pope Francis, dashing the hopes of women's rights groups after the bill was approved by legislature's lower house a few months earlier. The vote was 38 against, 31 in favor, with two abstentions. And that's where we leave your morning news. I'll have another update for you at the top of the hour.
Cricket first, and getting set to conclude the Proteas tour of Sri Lanka with one final once-off T20 next Tuesday. Sri Lankan captain Dinesh Chandimal is back after serving his international ban for refusing to take the field during their test series against the West Indies relating to accusations of ball tampering. And ahead of a brief break for the weekend, last night's only fixture in the PSL gave us four goals as Highland Spark drew 2-2 with Black Leopards. The league resumes next Tuesday at 7:30 with a spirited Baraka up against a tentative Chief. And just in time to get us excited at the return of European football, UEFA released their shortlist for the cream of the crop of last season. Liverpool's Mo Salah joining the usual suspects Ronaldo and Messi for best forward. Of course, defender will see Marcelo up against Sergio Ramos and Rafael Varane. And in the midfield, it's Kevin De Bruyne alongside Toni Kroos and Luka Modric. We'll find out who will win their respective awards on the 30th of August. And then finally, albeit quieter than normal in yesterday's Premier League transfer deadline, of course, moved forward to the day before today's season start for the first time. The move of the day was Colombian World Cup star Yerry Mina signing to Everton from Barcelona. Toffees spending a lot. In fact, the big disappointment, Man United not finding their centre-back, and we'll see if there are any holes left to plug as they kick-start the league tonight at 9 o'clock, hosting Leicester City at Old Trafford. We're going to open those lines to get your predictions on the English Premier League in just a moment. 021-430-9881. You could start dialing right now, but let's get the traffic in.
Let's take a quick look at the roads in Gauteng and Alberton. There's been an accident, and this is on the N3 northbound after the Grey Avenue exit. I'll have another update for you in half an hour.
More than a club, more than an appliance brand, Defy.
It's time to have a look at your weather. Second report for this morning. Very cold start to the morning with showers expected for the Eastern Cape. Strong west-south-westerly winds of 32 kilometres an hour can be expected for East London. Starting off with Polokwane at 8 and a high of 24. Mbombela, lows of 11 and highs of 28. Pretoria at 4 and a high of 20. Johannesburg expects some thunder showers there, starting off at lows of 1 and highs of 18. Mahikeng minus 1 and highs of 17. Klerksdorp 0 and 17. Kimberley 0 and highs of 13. Bloemfontein, it's cloudy with minus 4 and 12. Richards Bay, expect some rain there, lows of 11 and highs of 22. Pietermaritzburg 4 and 20. Durban 14 and 22. Mthatha 5 and highs of 14, with East London starting off at 9 and ending off at highs of 14. I'll be back again in half an hour with your next report.
All right, so many permutations ahead of a brand new Premier League season. Of course, it gets started tonight at 9 o'clock at Old Trafford. when Man United, Jose Mourinho's Come Man United, will be hosting Leicester City.
Getting vocal.
I mean, Jose, normally we'll wait at least one or two games before he starts mouthing off. Yeah. But of course, he's had some frustrations.
The entire preseason, he's moaning. And I understand.
Justifiably?
Because no defender, they couldn't get a defender in. They're hoping for another midfielder. That didn't happen. Strikers. And now the big cloud of Paul Pogba still hanging over Old Trafford. Because the other league's transfer windows close later, he can still leave in the next few weeks.
Can Mourinho still leave? Do you think he's going to stay at Man United, buddy?
I'll be surprised if he leaves now, but perhaps by the next transfer window, because nothing has happened now. So the start of the season, you know, it depends on how they respond. Paul Pogba, if he stays and how he performs. We saw at the World Cup, he's brilliant, but Mourinho wants him to track back. That's the problem. Let him play, man.
Can the real Paul Pogba please stand up?
All right, we've got our first caller on the line this morning. Merlin joining us. Very good morning to you, Merlin.
Hey, what's up, guys? Good morning. How are you doing?
Very well, man. Good to have you on the line. We're talking Premier League action starting off this weekend. What's your take? What are your score predictions? What are you looking for this season?
Obviously, Liverpool, you never walk alone. We're going to have another good season. I just wanted to correct our panelist there. He said Liverpool spent the most on a goalkeeper. Chelsea broke the world record. Actually, in 71, Liverpool spent 65 on Alisson. So just a small correction there on you.
Maybe they hosted him for a really expensive breakfast. they kind of, you know, sweetened the deal with something. So
that's how you guy, Aretha Balaga.
Aretha. Liverpool did spend and spend a lot in terms of that overall squad look. Klopp looks very pleased with his setup here. How are you feeling about Liverpool's defensive capability going into the season? Will it stand up to win a title?
I think you got to look at it from front to back. Because remember, Liverpool defend from the front. So the front three, that's where the press starts from. And if you look at Liverpool's spine, that's where they've improved. They've got Alisson in the back. They've got Van Dijk in the center back. They've got Fabiano and Keita, as well as Henderson, and they've got Firmino in the front. So if you look at Liverpool's spine, that's where they've strengthened. I know we might need another centre-back, but we've got a good youngster, Nat Phillips, coming in from the academy. So I think that's why Liverpool didn't spend money on another centre-back. If you follow them properly, you'll see that the youngsters are doing quite well in the academy. So I'm very optimistic. Cautiously optimistic about Liverpool should do this, yeah.
I think
the first
everyone.
Cautiously optimistic Liverpool fan I've ever heard of. But you sound like you've got your finger on the pulse, Merlin. What's your score prediction on Sunday? You guys are taking on West Ham in your season opener.
West Ham, 3-0.
Wasn't cautiously optimistic at all, man. Merlin, we love your style, my friend. Thank you so much for joining the conversation. We'll be catching up with you, I have a feeling, on Monday as well. But enjoy it, man. Enjoy all the drama coming this weekend. Can I say it straight out that the best signing this season was keeping Harry Kane? Because I would imagine there must have been.
Of course, Glenn.
Congratulations on the new baby, Sir Kane.
He's a dad.
Give it to him, man. Yeah. Give it to him. But Spurs, they've got such a wonderful dynamic. Yeah. I know they were going after Jack Grealish as well from Aston Villa. It would have been a great addition, but they've got a team that can win this title. Can they do it this year?
Yeah, I would have liked an extra striker. For me, with the Spurs, I think they rely too much on Kane. As brilliant as he is, you know, if you want to win the Champions League, you need two guys who's world-class up front. But they have a very solid squad, particularly defensively. They're solid midfield as well. But the support for Kane, hopefully Eriksen and the boys can step up again.
Alderweireld staying as well, which is a great, great thing. Ash, I love your style, my friend. Come on, good luck tonight.
Yeah,
we'll allow you to be completely unobjective this evening, but we'll catch up with you on Monday again. Thank you so much to all of our callers.
Yeah. Right now, of course, it's the weekend, and we have just what you've been craving for live right now from the studio. We have the Roger Good Show's Sureshni Ryder, June, and Miss Cosmo on the line. Good morning, letters!
Hurrah! How you doing, gentlemen?
Hurrah. That is the
very
cutest,
hurrah.
Sweetest hurrah I've ever heard. How are you feeling? It's the weekend, baby. Happy Women's Day, first of all, for yesterday to all of your team as well. You gorgeous ladies. What have you got for us? What's happening over the weekend?
Oh, it's going to be a massive bumper weekend. Let's kick it off in Johannesburg, the Gig Guide. We're kicking it off with the Blacks Only Comedy Show, which takes place, taking at the Ticket Pro Dome in Johannesburg. It's in its 15th year. The Blacks Only Comedy Show is the biggest comedy brand in the country and, of course, the most anticipated event on the social calendar. And, of course, it showcases the country's top comedians. This year, the show is celebrating David Kao's comedy journey of 20 years.
Wow.
And the theme, how amazing? And the theme this year is joke appropriation without compensation. So that was your chance to laugh your socks up and get your tickets now. Taking place on Saturday, the 11th of August, kicks off at 8 o'clock. Ticket prices only 250 rand to 775. In the capital, we go Pretoria. Kwezi is the show to watch at the SA State Theatre. And if you didn't know, Kwezi is a powerful stage drama that depicts the life of Fezekile and Sukela Kuzwayo and the events that led her and her mother to walk away from the land whose liberation her father's sole purpose was to free. It's an extremely poignant and relevant piece, especially for Women's Month. We are reminded that she was not just a body or a metaphor. And you can check out Kwezi Saturday, the 11th of August at 8 p.m. Ticket ranges from 110 rand to 140 rand. Durban, the warmest place under the African sun, is hosting the ever-popular Durban Comedy Jam. And that takes place at the Southern Sun Ilangeni and Maharani Hotel. It's some of the best stand-up comedians in the country appearing at Durban's premier monthly gig. So if you've never been for, it's a combination of experience and exciting young talent that make for an electrifying evening of great laughter. And of course, it's set against the backdrop of the picturesque Durban beachfront. That is Saturday, 11th August, 8 p.m. and tickets only at 150 rand. That's us. What do you have?
Oh, I love that. Go and support local theatre, local comedians. And we've got Decorix, I cannot believe, celebrating their 25th year this year.
Yeah.
Decorix Joburg, the 2018 edition, set to be, I think, the best yet by the sounds of it, the country's top interior designers and decor specialists, spanning seven halls at Gallagher Estate, showcasing the latest lifestyle and decor trends. Soosh, can we get it? Can I get the sweetest, cutest, most
women's
feminine
month.
Women's Month-inspired hoorah?
Of course, boys. Hoorah!
Oh, man, my heart just melts.
Lots and lots of tribute messages.
Wait.
Lots and lots of tribute messages have been pouring after the loss of life by a pro kid yesterday. And when we come back from the break, we will be paying tribute to him here on the Feel Good Breakfast Show Expresso.
Our condolences certainly going out to his family and friends and fans. And then also we'll take a look at the movies that you can catch on SABC3 this weekend. So don't go anywhere. We'll see you after the break.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show. Feel Good Breakfast Show.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back. You're live with Expresso. Thank you so much for tuning in on this Friday morning. A somber Friday morning at that. What a hectic day yesterday. Heartbreaking,
certainly,
in fact. Yeah.
Certainly in terms of local entertainment news. This week, in fact, South Africa had to bid farewell to a hip-hop legend, Ulinda Pro Kid Mkhize. Oh, man, we said dankie-san for one last time. He sadly passed away at the age of 37. Now, according to a statement released by his family, Pro Kid suffered a severe seizure attack on Wednesday, the 8th of August, while visiting friends. And they said that paramedics, and I quote, paramedics were called to in to assist, and they did their best to revive him to no avail. And now, of course, sadly, Pro Kid leaves his family behind, his wife Ayanda and his three-year-old daughter Nonganyezi, and many more. Local celebrities have taken to Twitter, of course, to express their shock and sadness following the death. One of them, Nandima Dida, says, to anyone reading this, mourn the way you see fit to mourn an incredible artist who moved people in different ways. None of us will ever know how many lives this king touched, and you have every right to feel hurt by the passing of a very humble, talented soul. And Proverb, also one of those adding his word to the mournful cries on social media, saying, praying the news isn't true, but if it is, then my brother, I wish you safe passage into heaven. You were indeed a pioneer, a legend, and one incredible MC. And for the record, I never considered you a pro kid, but rather a pro king. Yeah, these were just some of the tweets that came in.
I mean, it's a two-edged sword when social media explodes with this kind of news, apart from all of the misinformation going around, but hopefully in some way it does allow the family to feel some of that love, but that what there is nothing you can say or do in that situation. So we send so much love as well.
Yeah, and continuing with the tragic news, Sibatle Mpisane, aka Fitness Bunny, she was involved in a car accident on Thursday morning, which has left her fighting for her life, I quote, in ICU. Now, according to her, obviously, and very understandably emotional father, Sibu Mpisane, he said, it's really bad. I don't know where she was coming from, but she's in ICU fighting for her life at the St. Augustine Hospital in Durban. Now, Spartley was allegedly driving her new car down the Victoria Embankment when the accident happened. A KZN SAPS spokesperson said that the accident took place at around 4:20 a.m. when the vehicle crashed and then burst into flames at the Victoria Embankment opposite the Wilson Wharf. Now, the driver was injured and taken to hospital for medical attention. And the cause of the accident is unknown at this stage. And a case of reckless and negligent driving has been opened in Durban Central Police Station. But certainly our thoughts and prayers are with her and her family. And of course, we wish her a very speedy recovery. The pictures paint a very, very grim image indeed.
I know I'm harping on it, but I'll say again, just tread lightly on social media today around these sorts of things. Send love or send nothing at all.
Absolutely, I agree with that. But yeah, sorry about that, guys. Unfortunately, it is the reality of the current state of things, but we'll keep trying to uplift the mood on your feel-good breakfast show. It is, after all, a Friday.
This week on Top Billing, Maps Moponyani explores Greece and its gastronomy, while Jeannie D visits the Garment District in New York. Catch all of this and more on Top Billing at 6 p.m. tomorrow and repeat 12 midday on Sunday.
Join the party on Top Billing this Saturday evening at 6 as we go on site with a groundbreaking businesswoman lighting the way for others in an oh-so-male industry.
I'm here with powerhouse construction guru, Thobekile Ndlovu.
I'm putting Jade to work this week in construction.
In New York, Jeannie shops at the world's most famous fabric store, then learns to design and make her own summer dress in a day.
What was the inspiration behind the fashion experience?
We were getting so many calls from people visiting New York City, people that love to watch shows like Project Runway or Fashion Week, and they wanted to have this true New York City experience in the Garment District.
Maps learns the Greek arts of Gethi, or enjoying life, as he immerses himself in 3,000 years of history and gets a spa treatment the way nature intended.
It's a really weird experience, and I'm not the most ticklish person out there, but I can actually feel them starting to go under my feet, in the crevices of my toes, and just nibbling away, but It's a strange feeling, but I think I'll get used to it.
Straight from her garden, the queen of organic, sustainable cooking blends buchu, rooibos, and confetti bush with world flavors at her latest restaurant.
Today, world-traveled and award-winning chef Nikki Gibbs invites us into her home for an intimate and relaxed lunch experience at her very own Crofter's Kitchen here in Nodu.
We get to know Dr. Fezile Mkize, Raul de Mone, and myself, Harmony Catalani, Top Billing's new trio of leading men, otherwise known as the League of Extraordinary Gentlemen.
For the first time in a while, I'm looking forward to taking a bit of a breather on Top Billing, and the League takes over.
Yeah, I think we're definitely ready to step out of this big shadow.
Catch all this greatness on Saturday at 6 p.m. on SABC3, where the stage is yours.
I got a big shadow, guys.
Can you step back? Well, it's our time.
It's our turn.
It's our time.
The League. Shoes to fall.
Assemble.
Big shoes.
Assemble. It's the League.
How cute are they?
The League of Extraordinary Gentlemen, indeed, man. Still so proud of all of our presenters, search on three winners. But of course, more reasons to stay tuned to three this weekend. We've got a fantastic movie lineup. I'm going to kick it off with what's coming at you tonight at 9:30, right here on three. As part of a great movie lineup, evocative as it is, we're going to start with Injinga, Queen of Angola, an action-adventure drama set in the 17th century. It follows a warrior woman who, after witnessing the murder of her son and watching her people being humiliated by Portuguese colonizers, fights for the independence of Angola.
In a country that was once free, and celebrations were a norm, when her land was invaded, she wanted justice. She fought for her people, freedom, and her kingdom. Injinga, Queen of Angola, Friday at 9:30 on 3. The stage is yours.
I think you said it. That's like the first ever.
That's right. Well, on Saturday, we're also shaking things up with bringing SABC3's bringing you a Chinese movie. And this one is a film starring Gong Li. And it's the story of Zhao Yu, a ceramic artist from Sanming, who falls in love with a poet from Shangyang. And the film explores Zhao Yu's character and the people she meets on her train journey to meet this man. So let's check it out.
This Saturday, take a train ride with us on a journey of love. A painter obsessed with beauty. A writer possessed with poetry. A stranger fueled by desire. She would go anywhere her heart would take her. A story of love, lust, and betrayal. Tsuyu's Train, Saturday at 7 on 3. The stage is yours.
Wow, a lovely balanced movie lineup this weekend. I think something inspired by Women's Month. Of course, all August we are celebrating South Africa's incredible woman. But that's what you've got to look forward to on your movie lineup right here on 3. The stage is yours.
Well, you certainly hope that you do enjoy the weekend. Now, of course, here at Expresso, we're all about giving back. And when you are giving back, whether it's in a form of a simple donation or you start your own charity, what matters is that you do it because it is impactful and it is meaningful. And most people have a desire to do good. And that's exactly what we want to encourage you as our Expresso family to do, to get involved as we help CHOC, the Childhood Cancer Foundation, to raise funds for their new house in Pretoria.
Now, if you would like to get involved, you can donate by using the Zapa app on your cell phone. Simply scan the QR code and donate. The Zapa QR code will be visible on your screen for the next hour, available for you to scan right off your screen and help make a difference. Yeah. For more details, of course, you can go on our Expresso website and check that out.
Every day that brave young kids and their families battle cancer, the CHOC Childhood Cancer Foundation supports them. And here at Expresso, we'd love you to help us fund their newest CHOC home in Pretoria. Donate with your phone, download the Zapa app free from your app store, scan the QR code, or follow the instructions on the Expresso website.
Please get on it right now. Even just 10 Rand will make a massive difference, and you can see that QR code on your screen right now. We're going to take the quickest of breaks. Then I don't know, how do you feel about designing your own baby? It might just be happening. We'll find out in our tech update.
Too many choices, I can tell you that. But something you must choose is to stay tuned to your Feel Good Breakfast show. We have Rocco de Villiers that's definitely going to take our Friday to
we
a
see
Friday.
The knees, please.
And he's performing Court Brook, which he's currently wearing. I think the only person I know that will wear a Court Brook in this cold weather. But we'll see you after the break.
It's tough getting up in the morning. That's why for breakfast, I'm making eggs Benedict. Get it? I just love a good food pun. Share your photo and recipe of your favorite winter dish with the hashtag #ForTheLoveOfWinter, and you could win 5,000 Rand in weekly prizes and stand a chance to win a grand prize of 100,000 Rand. Rhodes Quality, for the love of winter.
Rise and shine with your feel-good breakfast show, Expresso.
Welcome back. It's your Feel Good Breakfast show on a Friday morning. Rocco de Villiers is in the studio and he joins us at the release of his 14th studio album called Kortbroek Lanko. So that once again celebrates his extraordinary piano playing style as he celebrates some of the music that identifies with him and who he is. And here he is right now performing a song that's quite fitted to our Feel Good Breakfast show called Goeie Gevoel.
Thank you.
fantastic performance by Rocco de Villiers, who will be performing again on your Feel Good Breakfast show. It's that time of the morning for us to touch on your national headlines. President Cyril Ramaphosa has announced that a national gender summit will be held on 31 August to deal with issues of gender-based violence. Ramaphosa delivered the keynote address at the National Women's Day celebrations in Paarl yesterday morning. He called for a moment's silence to remember women who had been brutalized and exploited. He told the thousands of attending the event in Mbekweni, Paarl, that men should hang their heads in shame. He said women should feel protected, whether they are in streets or on village pathways, at work, or just going about their daily lives. And meanwhile, in Johannesburg later yesterday, President Ramaphosa said the SA government should not allow land grabs and anarchy in the process of finding a solution for the land issue. He was speaking at a conference attended by investors who had expressed an interest in the South African government's efforts to attract new foreign direct investment of $100 million over the next 5 years. Ramaphosa said the land issue will be addressed in such a way that the outcome is good for all South Africans. And in international news, some dozen writers from African and Middle East countries hoping to attend a book festival in Scotland this weekend have had their visa applications refused. This is according to the event organizers. Edinburgh International Book Festival director Nick Barley said that although he realizes it is systematic, it is a very serious matter. The festival organizers haven't named the authors in question. At last month's WOMAD festival, at least three African acts on the bill were unable to perform due to visa complications with British immigration. And lastly, Argentina senators yesterday voted against legalization of abortion in the homeland of Pope Francis, dashing the hopes of women's rights groups after the bill was approved by the legislature's lower house some months earlier. The vote, 38 against, 31 in favor with two abstentions, capped a marathon session that began the day before and stretched into the early hours of yesterday. The vote followed a referendum in Ireland, another traditionally Catholic country, in May that paved the way to legislate for the termination of fetuses. That's where I leave your morning headlines. Let's take a look at your sport.
We kick it off with cricket this morning, getting set to conclude the Proteas tour of Sri Lanka with a once-off T20 next Tuesday. Sri Lankan captain Dinesh Chandimal is back after serving his international ban for refusing to take the field during their test series against the West Indies, relating to accusations of ball tampering. He's in the 15-man squad for the shortest format, but not for Sunday's final ODI. With the series at 3-1, the Proteas will again be led by Quinton de Kock in the absence of the injured Puff Duplessis before JP Germany steps in on Tuesday. Then ahead of a brief break for the weekend, last night's only fixture in the PSL gave us four goals as Highlands Park drew 2-2 with Black Leopards. Lucky boy McQuena got Highlands off the mark from range in a night that really tested Leopards' diminutive shot stopper Rashidzwa Moleka. While Bevan Fransman was marshalling a solid defence, Highlands let Leopards back in the game in the second. The league resumes next Tuesday at 7:30 in the evening with a spirited Baraka up against a tentative Chiefs. And just in time to get us excited at the return of European football, UEFA released their shortlist for their cream of the crop of last season. Liverpool's Mo Salah understandably joins the usual suspects, Ronaldo and Messi, for best forward. Last year's winner, now in Italy, Ronaldo a shoo-in with his 15 goals for the reigning European champions. Salah had a remarkable run to the finals with 10 goals, Messi in there with 6. Best defender sees Marcelo up against Sergio Ramos and Rafael Varane. And in the midfield, it's Kevin De Bruyne featuring alongside Real's duo of Toni Kroos and Luka Modric. The winners will be announced in Monaco on the 30th of August at the group stage draw. Then, albeit quieter than normal, in yesterday's Premier League transfer deadline moved forward to the day before today's season start for the first time. The move of the day was Colombian World Cup star Yerry Mina signing to Everton from Barcelona. Toffees also landing Barca's Andre Gomez and Brazilian winger Bernard. I think the most publicised disappointment, Jose Mourinho unable to find a credible centre-back. We'll see if there are any notable holes in their defence as Man United get the league underway at Old Trafford tonight against Leicester City, that game at 9 o'clock. That's where we leave our sport for now.
Let's take another look at the roads. In the Western Cape in Athlone, there's a stationary vehicle. It's on the N2 inbound. It's after Jan Smuts Drive, currently blocking the right lane. And in Gauteng and Pretoria and Linwood on the N1 southbound, there's also been an accident. That's after Rigel Avenue. Three lanes have been blocked. You can expect major delays this morning, so allow for some extra travel time. That's where we leave your traffic for now.
More than a club, more than an appliance brand, Defy.
Hey, look at your weather once again. It's freezing cold in Cape Town, and I feel like I'm not appropriately dressed. Very cold start to the morning with showers expected for the Eastern Cape. Strong west and southwesterly winds of 32 kilometers an hour can be expected for East London. Polokwane at lows of 8 and a high of 24. Mbombela 11 and 28. Pretoria, low of 4 and a high of 20. Johannesburg starting off at 1 and a high of 18. Mahikeng, minus 1 and 17. Klerksdorp, 0 and 17. Kimberley 0 and 13, Bloemfontein minus 4 and 12, Richards Bay at low of 11 and highs of 22, and it's rainy there. Pietermaritzburg 4 and 20, Durban 14 and 22, Mthatha 5 and 14, East London 9 and 14 and rainy, Craydock minus 1 and 11, Port Elizabeth with 7 and 14, George 6 and 13, Sutherland minus 2 and a high of 8, Cape Town 6 and 16, Worcester 2 and high of 14, Springbok 3 and 12, Upington minus 1 and 15. Keep warm today, South Africa.
Well, before we let you snuggle up with a good book, of course, I think we're going to open a can of worms with our tech update this morning, Designer Babies. I'll leave it there.
Just leave it right there. But also, we have the opportunity to chat to Rusty Labuschagne, the author of this book called Beating Chains, that tells the harrowing story of how he spent 10 years in a Zimbabwean prison after being falsely accused of a crime. And it's going to be quite a telling story. So stay tuned for that and more. We'll be right back.
All Expresso presenters and guests fly domestically with Mango. Enjoy outstanding service, online check-in and seat selection. With the widest booking and payment options, Mango is the only airline globally to accept store charge cards as a means of payment. Fly in comfort with ergonomically efficient seats for more legroom aboard a fleet of new generation Boeing 737-800 aircraft. Join the presenters of Expresso and fly Mango.
It's my feel good breakfast show.
Welcome back. It is your feel good breakfast show. It's a Friday morning, and thanks so much for starting the day off with us. Now, last week we chatted about a lab grown lung that was planted into a pig, and it works perfectly. And one might think like, okay, that's weird enough. But right now, we're talking about things in technology that will blow your mind. Completely bizarre. Scientists are experimenting with something called CRISPR. And they're doing this in the United States that might allow us to one day be able to genetically make babies exactly the way that we want them to be made, which is very, very scary.
I can't believe it.
Are we there already in that kind of world? Yeah. Theunis Jansen van Rensburg joining us to talk about that.
Theunis, welcome.
Thank you very much.
Please tell us, you have to get straight into it. What is this CRISPR?
Right, so CRISPR is essentially a gene editing tool. It was basically thought of as how our actual DNA learns over time what diseases to have an immunity to, and just from that kind of same mechanism, that's where CRISPR comes from. So essentially, CRISPR can split your genome in half and insert the other piece that would stop a disease from happening again if you've had a cold or a flu or whatever the case may be.
Yeah.
So that's where the technology comes from, and now they're using it in obviously much different ways.
Yeah, but let's quickly try and understand first, what is it that scientists are doing with human embryos, and what is it that they're trying to achieve?
Right, so it's a new study that came out in 2017, and now it's being kind of ridiculed and it's going back and forth. But essentially they created human embryos, and they used this technology to cut out a mutation in the genome. So
yes.
There's a specific type of gene that especially athletes suffer from, and it's basically a heart condition that is passed on from the mother and the father.
Mm-hmm.
So they inserted this mutation into an embryo, and then they use CRISPR to try to remove that. And that's where they want to go with CRISPR, is removing genetic mutations.
Yeah.
Cancer genes.
Yeah.
All of those kind of diseases is what they want to cut out with CRISPR.
This is absolutely wild. I mean, obviously something like this would be hugely controversial. The science community has not taken all too well to this. What are some of the results they found that everyone is just ridiculing, thinking is ridiculous rather?
Yeah, so the reason it's controversial is because they are doing these experiments with human embryos.
Yeah.
Mm. So it is illegal in the US to harvest an embryo and do the tests from them, so they have to fertilize the eggs themselves. Mm. And that's why people are not too happy with it. But the results from it is very promising. So they were able to cut out those mutations in the genes, and people are questioning whether we should go forward with this because it is actually working.
Yeah,
and as you rightly say, that means in a decade's time, you can potentially choose the color of your baby's eyes and their hair, and should they be muscular or not. And all these kind of things will start happening with CRISPR over time.
Yeah, so I guess the big question is, I mean, you just said now in a decade's time, do you think that we'll see this in our lifetime where you can basically have a designer baby? And I mean, there's a potential that the poverty gap or the wealth gap will get even bigger.
Widen.
Because the richer will get richer, the poorer will get poorer. If you can afford to make sure that your child has a certain percentile of IQ and is capable in certain ways that will advance them in the world, others can't do that.
Yeah.
Are we going to see that in our lifetime?
I think so. I mean, the biggest stumbling block isn't the technology, it's the morals and the ethics around it, and how people are going to have that pushback. I do think, though, at the end of the day, we're going to use it first to get rid of those mutated genes, get rid of the diseases, and then you might have the super rich people that put blue eyes in their kids that just look strange, that shouldn't be there.
Yeah, I think we all just need to start being more spatially aware. Look around you, the world is changing at quite
fast.
A rapid rate, man.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, Theunis, always for coming around with your expertise and your insights. And let us know which stories you've been following from the world of technology around. When you do share them with us, please use hashtag Expresso Show.
Hard work certainly deserves to be awarded. And when it comes to great service, Caltex just knows the way to make their customers happy and get them there. And as a thank you for the hard-working service attendants, Caltex Bunyan pulled out all of the stops to give their staff a day full of surprises and awards.
The way to a customer's heart is about creating an experience worth talking about. If one thing is certain, it's that the service attendants at Caltex Bunyan know how to give the best service in town. Did you know that Caltex Bunyan has one of the highest rated services in the country? To say thank you for all the hard work that these customer service attendants do on a daily basis, they have something exciting planned.
The petrol attendants, they are always welcoming when we speak to them. That is why I always come to this filling station. When you come over here, you just distress about everything else.
Petrol attendants are friendly because they're always laughing, talkative, and do things fast.
Although it's clear that these service attendants expect nothing in return for their incredible service, Caltex are recognizing how they are helping to get customers there and rewarding them for a job well done. The unexpected moment is always sweeter. In just a couple of seconds, some of the Orlando Pirates players will surprise the unexpecting service attendants, and I can't wait to see their reaction.
because when the van arrived, they probably thought that, nah, they're just coming here to pour some petrol. It's just a random Orlando Pirates van, you know, just passing by the station. They had no idea that all of that was for them. It's so, so rewarding being part of this day because so many of us encounter petrol attendants in our day-to-day lives, but they are seldom appreciated and celebrated. So it was nice being part of the celebration, nice to honor them and make them feel special as well and make them feel appreciated.
I think it's a nice experience being here because a lot of people were not even expecting us to be here and that we've come here to celebrate the great work that they're doing. In my mind, I was very, very excited because I'm a very, very big Pirate supporter from long time, many years ago. So now when they tell me about the Orlando Pirates players are coming here, so I was very, very happy.
Everybody wants to be rewarded for the work that they do and, you know, to be acknowledged. This is the experience that you get at all Caltex garages, then this is the place to be, man. You know, to be partnered with Caltex and you can see the work that they are doing. You know, it's just it's an honor to be here and, you know, we're really looking forward to the partnership going ahead.
Today I feel so happy. Today, I mean, it's the best day of my life. I didn't see anything like this. It's the first time. It shows that my work is being recognized by Caltex. Makes me happy.
Everyone is happy, as you can see behind us, behind you guys, they are dancing there. Everyone is happy, atmosphere is good, everyone is smiling, it's all smiles.
But I was way too surprised, like, yeah, it is really happening, and they were there and they give us the spirit. We felt everything, every moment. When you work hard, it's the time you get rewards, and it's the time that everyone notices the effort that you put in every day.
It feels good to be here today. We all know that the club has a partnership with Caltex and we got a good welcome. We're happy to be here. The customers are happy, you know, the workers are happy, and as Pirates players, we're also happy to be here.
Caltex is a brand that will take you places, and Pirates is a brand that's moving places, so it's quite nice. It's going to be a good partnership that's going to be there.
Seeing the reaction was amazing. It was awesome. You know, you could see that it is resonating with the CSAs, and it is really a great way of appreciating them, and it touched the right, you know, nerves.
To sum up the day, I would say that I'm really, really, really happy to have been part of this initiative. I'm so happy to have made a difference in these guys' lives. My favorite moment of today had to be when these guys received their certificates and seeing their faces light up because they've been so appreciated.
To me, to win this award, it's not for me, it's about us. All of us, they have done the good job. We've done the good job.
It's been so special being here today and seeing the quality of service that Caltex brings to their customers. It's clear that teamwork and spirit is what sets them apart from the rest.
A feel-good story for this weekend. And Caltex is getting you there by giving you the chance to win a Caltex voucher card to the value of 5,000 Rand. All you have to do is SMS the keyword Caltex, your name and city to 33728, and you could be walking away with a 5,000 Rand voucher card. VAS rates apply, and those T's and C's can be found on our website. Visit expressoshow.com to find them.
Quality fuel, convenience, and service with a smile. Whether it's to fuel up or stock up, Caltex, it's how you get there.
Now imagine for a moment the amount of growth that you've experienced in your life over the past 10 years. Now imagine all of that was taken away from you overnight, just like that. Now this only begins to describe the experience that Rusty Labuschagne went through when he was falsely imprisoned for murder in Zimbabwe. In 2013, he was released after spending 10 years behind bars for a crime that he didn't commit. And since then, he has shared the story of how he overcame immense adversity and also has written a book called Beating Chains, which I hold in my hand. And Rusty, it's such a privilege to have you here with us, and to see the smile on your face warms the heart. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Kat.
So if you could, and I know this is probably a story that you've told over and over again, but take us back to that fateful fishing trip in Zimbabwe and how, what the circumstances were around you getting to prison in Zimbabwe.
It was December 2000, and I went on a fishing trip with friends of mine to my fishing resort on Lake Kariba. And late one afternoon, one of my mates and I decided to go target fishing on the lake, leaving the other guys bream fishing in the river. Mm-hmm. And on our way back, we spotted two fish poachers in a steel boat who immediately upon seeing us started paddling hastily for the shore in an effort to get away from us. And knowing that there were known poachers, I drove my boat towards them to scare them off, and the wake of my boat tilted their boat, causing them to jump out into the water, which was about 1.5 meters deep.
Yeah.
They were about 3 meters from the shore and soon scrambled to dry land. Then my friend and I watched as they ran away into the bush, thinking nothing more of it. The following day, the police arrived and accused us of drowning one of those poachers. To cut a long story short, I was framed by the poacher, the police, and the courts in an ugly political conspiracy against police evidence, without a body and on presumptions. I was convicted of drowning that poacher and spent sentenced to 15 years, of which 5 were suspended.
That is... I can't even wrap my mind around how that must feel when that initial encounter even happens and you're accused of this. But fast forward through the legal process or the lack thereof, here you find yourself in prison in your first few days. Take me through that experience and what that was like for you.
So what they do get there is you get to the prison after you're sentenced, and before you walk into the maximum security exercise yard, it's a 20-foot wide wall with huge wooden doors. They make you strip naked, and you walk in stark naked. There were 1,000 guys in there, and I was the only white guy. And they escort you to the guards that are all sitting down, and they question you over and over, naked and terrified. And then finally they gave me one set of clothing, one shirt and one pair of drawstring white shorts. That is the only pair of clothing you're allowed at any one time for the first 8 years. They escorted me up to my cell that was 13 meters long by 3 meters wide. We were 78 guys. So everybody got 33 centimeters of space marked out on the walls in chalk. So you're packed like sardines with legs all crossing over in the middle because it's only 3 meters wide. And you all faced the same direction. When you turned over, it was all together. And as cushioning against the cold concrete floor, you'd fold two of your paper-thin, worn-out, lice-ridden blankets several times to fit your space, then covered yourself with a third one. And then we had no basins or taps in the cells and only one set of clothing at any one time. So we had to wash our clothes in the cell toilets at night wearing a blanket, then hang them on the walls with smuggled book staples to dry by the next morning.
Wow.
And then in 2005, Harare City ran out of water. So for 3 years, while in Chikubri Maximum Security Prison, every prisoner was allocated one plastic cup of water a day. That was to drink, clean your teeth, wash your face, bath, everything for 3 years.
And that's just the beginning of the entire story. 10 years later, you're out, and what completely perplexes me is how you even learned the lesson of complete and utter forgiveness out of this entire ordeal. And we will find out more about that. Stay tuned to your Feel Good Breakfast show. More with Rusty Labuschagne after the break.
Wrap up the week in style with Afternoon Express live at 4:30 on SABC3 as we catch up with renowned fashion designer Gert-Johan Coetzee. Recently, he formed an unlikely collaboration with one of the world's biggest brands. Plus, we have songstress Amy Jones, who rose to fame in 2013 as one of the finalists in SA's top talent shows, performs live. That's Afternoon Express weekdays at 4:30 on SABC3. The stage is yours.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back to your Feel Good Breakfast Show on this Friday morning. We have with us Rusty Labuschagne, author of Beating Chains, a book that tells his story, his ordeal, after being wrongfully accused and convicted for murder in Zimbabwe in 2003. 10 years later, he walks out of prison a changed man. One who's learned forgiveness in extraordinary circumstances. But I want to just quickly go back to the fact that there was a lot happening in Zimbabwe during this time while you were in prison. There was the economic crash. Where were you reaching out to for help? I mean, Zimbabwe is a neighboring country to South Africa. Did you have contact with the outside world? Did you know how long you were going to be in prison for when you walked in?
No. After I was sentenced, I knew that I was going to be there 10 years. Yeah. But what I'd like to emphasize, Kat, is the power of hope when you're in that situation. I was always going home, no.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
And I had
endless
promises that you're going home, no. If I had to think in there that I was going to spend even 3 years in there, it would have been a different mindset completely.
Yeah. So then, the existence of hope, and you talk about thinking, just no, it's going to happen.
Yeah.
What was your ultimate low point when you realized that it's not going to be no?
I never, ever didn't realize that. I remained focused that I was going home for 10 years.
And throughout this, you also then became a source of hope for other prison inmates there with your leadership skills, with your views on positive existence. How did those save you and at the end teach you the unconditional forgiveness that you were telling me about early?
Kat, the humiliation of being labeled a murderer and terrible conditions were extremely hard to deal with, as was the pain of my anger, bitterness, hatred, revenge, that was eating away at me every day. And I hated them bitterly for what they'd done and were doing to me.
Yeah.
And then, after about a year, I was tired of all the anger, hatred, and bitterness. It was draining me daily. And I remember the exact moment walking in that exercise yard, and I just said to myself, just let the Lord take care of them, and let me get through this road they'd been put in front of me.
Yeah.
And once I'd accepted that, my life in prison changed. But I think you have to be pushed that low to appreciate what forgiveness really is, like Nelson Mandela did.
Yeah.
And only when you're pushed that low, and under those conditions, watching people dying every day, the Zimbabwe crash was horrific. So there was no food outside of prison, never mind in there. And during my first 6 years, I watched over 2,200 people die in prison. So to overcome all of that, mentally, you've got to really stay focused.
Yeah.
And I never lowered myself to be affected by them because they try and break you. You know, when I went in there, I was flying my own aircraft. I had 5 businesses. I was doing really well. And full of confidence, flying high. And when you get in there, they crush you. They break your confidence, your spirit, everything.
Yeah.
And when you come out, you have to pick that up and keep going.
What do you want people to glean from your experience and from this book when they read it?
The power of forgiveness. The importance and value and gratitude, being thankful and grateful about who you are, what you have, and what you've achieved. So many people want too much in their lives, forgetting about what they have. And for me, it's about giving thanks every day and appreciate everyday little things in life, like a soft bed, a hot bath, a spontaneous cuddle from a loved one, because those are the things you miss most when you have it all taken away.
Yeah.
And then the power of freedom. People don't appreciate freedom. And only when you have your freedom completely taken away, do you realize in many ways that you're actually in prison too. And so our business partnerships, badly selected careers, being obsessed with money and ambition in the corporate world, even unhappy marriages. So when I look back on it all, it makes me realize that it makes me wish I could tell people how powerful and positive freedom is, true freedom.
Yeah.
So if people could learn those three things, that would be wonderful.
Ah, Rusty, thank you very, very much for joining us, for sharing your story, and I hope that it inspires so many
out there.
The book is available, and you can also follow at Beating Chains on social media for more information.
Matt Kat, it's available on www.beatingchains.com.
Thank you, sir.
My website.
There we go.
On that note, let's quickly touch on your national headlines. President Cyril Ramaphosa has announced that a national gender summit will be held on 31 August to deal with issues of gender-based violence. Speaking to thousands at the National Women's Day celebrations in Paarl yesterday morning, he said that men should hang their heads in shame and women should feel protected wherever they are. And in Johannesburg later yesterday, Ramaphosa said that SA government would not allow land grabs and anarchy in the process of finding a solution for the land issue. He said the land issue would be addressed in such a way that the outcome was good for all in South Africa. And moving to news abroad, some dozen writers from African and Middle East countries hoping to attend a book festival in Scotland this weekend have had their visa applications refused. At last month's WOMAD festival, at least three African acts on the bill were unable to perform due to visa complications with British immigration. And staying with news abroad, Argentina senators yesterday voted against legalizing abortion in the homeland of Pope Francis, dashing the hopes of women's rights groups after the bill was approved by legislature's lower house a few months earlier. The vote was 38 against, 31 in favor, with two abstentions. And that's where we leave your headlines. I'll bring you the full news at 8 o'clock.
In cricket, getting set to conclude the Proteas tour of Sri Lanka with a once-off T20 next Tuesday. Sri Lankan captain Dinesh Chandimal is back after serving his international ban for refusing to take the field during their test series against the West Indies recently, relating to accusations of ball tampering. And ahead of a brief break for the weekend, last night's only fixture in the PSL gave us four goals as Highlands Park drew 2-2 with Black Leopards. The league resumes next Tuesday at 7:30 in the evening with a spirited Baroka up against a tentative Kaizer Chiefs. And just in time to get us excited at the return of European football, UEFA have released their shortlist for their cream of the crop last season. Liverpool's Mo Salah joins the usual suspects Ronaldo and Messi for best forward. In the defenders category, Marcelo up against Sergio Ramos and Rafael Varane. And in the midfield, it's Kevin De Bruyne alongside Real's duo of Toni Kroos and Luka Modric. We'll find out who the winners are in their respective fields on the 30th of August. And in the English Premier League, about to resume tonight, albeit quieter than normal in yesterday's Premier League transfer deadline, moved forward to the day before today's season start for the first time. Move of the day had to be Colombian World Cup star Yerry Mina signing to Everton from Barcelona. And of course, Man United, probably the most disappointed camp out there. Jose Mourinho will see if he's got any holes to plug in his defence tonight as we get the season underway at Old Trafford as Man United face off against Leicester City. We'll expand on all of those stories on the top of the hour.
And it seems like most of South Africa has decided to take an extended weekend as all major routes are free-flowing this morning. We'll bring you another update if there is one at 8 o'clock.
Quality fuel, convenience and service with a smile. Whether it's to fuel up or stock up, Caltex, it's how you get there.
And another look at your weather this morning. Strong west and southwesterly winds of 32 kilometers per hour can be expected in East London. Polokwane is looking at lows of 8 and highs of 24 this morning. Mbombela 11 and 28. Pretoria 4 and 20. Johannesburg starting off at 1 and ending off on highs of 18. Mahikeng minus 1 and 17. Klerksdorp 0 and 17, Kimberley 0 and 13, Bloemfontein minus 4 and 12, Richards Bay 11 and 22 with rain, Pietermaritzburg 4 and 20, Durban is at 14 and highs of 22, Mthatha 5 and 14, East London 9 and 14 with those 32 kilometers per hour winds happening there, Craydock minus 1 and 11 was rainy there, PE 7 and 14, George 6 and 13, Sutherland lows of minus 2 and highs of 8, Cape Town 6 and 16, Worcester 2 and 14, Springbok 3 and highs of 12, with Upington minus 1 and highs of 15. Back with the next update in half an hour.
Wow. First of all, still reeling from the interview with Rusty. Yeah. That's just beyond comprehension.
Absolutely. Oh. But anyway, we'll take a pause from that to continue our celebrations of Women's Month as it is to be done in August, because it is, that's what it is.
So, of course, yesterday we commemorated the 20,000-some women that very bravely marched on the Union Buildings in Pretoria in 1956 in protest against pass laws. And we have been highlighting quotes from Women of Fortitude. Every
day this month being Women's Month. We are celebrating the incredible woman.
Absolutely.
Most notably those who have fought in the struggle.
Absolutely. And so today's Women of Fortitude is one who we sadly lost this past April, Umamwini Madikizela Mandela, a woman who, of course, was married to Tata Nelson Mandela for almost 40 years. And I think she perfectly encapsulates that spirit of resilience, of sacrifice, one which many, many stalwarts and women of that era certainly embody. And she said these words: to those who oppose us, we say, strike the woman and you strike the rock. Watinta bafazi, watinta impokoto. And that also became a chant and an anthem that is very synonymous with that time indeed. But what a woman of fortitude to admire, to look up to every day.
And I think forced to make some unbelievably difficult decisions throughout her time, like so many of the struggle icons. Mm-hmm. All we can do now is pay homage to her courageous spirit, to every woman that fought through that time specifically, but more importantly, do what we can to take that on board now. Through socio-economic pressures, we are still seeing so many South Africans as disenfranchised, as living under these same realities, which is just unacceptable. So, Mawini, we hopefully take that spirit forward today, and we'll continue to do this throughout the month of August.
Yeah, and also to all the women who continue to contribute to the making great of South Africa through every single sacrifice you make every day. Happy Women's Day, Women's Month, women every year to you.
Well, August is all about the ladies, and it's about celebrating the great things women are doing and how they're changing the world every day. And two such women are the powerhouse duo, Leanne Engelbrecht and Lungi Mnyamana, the marketing team behind SASKO. And today we tap into their success and get a little bit of a how-to guide on making your mark in the corporate world. Ladies, good morning.
Good morning,
Zoe. I'm so excited to pick your brain because the two of you are on such powerful positions, but I know it's been a journey.
Yeah.
And growing up, we all had ideas of where we would see ourselves one day. What was that dream for you, Leanne? Let's start with you.
Well, Zoe, you know, when I left school, I wanted to see what it would be like in psychology. And so I was really interested to become a clinical psychologist. But about sort of 2 years into that, I figured that my makeup wasn't quite right for it. I'd nevertheless finished that degree and then moved on into marketing. So I was really interested initially in psychology, but business then had my heart.
Okay, and then you moved into marketing. And Lungi, for you?
I really wanted to be a journalist. I mean, I remember days when I used to walk around my streets with a script in my hand saying I'm interviewing people everywhere. But obviously that literally changed over time, and I found myself in the corporate doing a BCom degree.
Okay, BCom. And then I think now the next question is, how did you end up in marketing? When did you realize you were made for marketing?
Well, I finished my undergraduate degree, and then subsequently I sort of went, well, what now, you know? And marketing actually found me, to be honest. So I went to university and I said, look, what's the next step? And I went into a program called the Postgraduate Marketing Diploma, also at UCT. Mm-hmm. And in the first few weeks, I knew it was for me. I enjoyed every minute of it. Initially research and, you know, a little bit of a different view of the world. And moving from humanities into commerce, it was quite a change, but I really thoroughly enjoyed it. And I figured this would be my career.
And look, it was...
Well, for me, I started in market research. Servicing clients in FMCG that are marketers, and the more time I spent with them, the more curious and interested I was in their jobs, and eventually found myself crossing over and did a postgrad in marketing through AAA School of Advertising, and that's how I came in.
It's very interesting. What would you ladies say, given that you've tapped into other industries before going into marketing, for someone that's interested in going into marketing, what type of personality or traits should they have to succeed?
For me, I think, Zoe, you have to be someone who's curious, because there's a lot of things that are happening that affect how you perceive the market and the work that you do. Mm-hmm. In your daily life, as you go into the stores, the people that you interact with, that is all influential in marketing. And I also think you must be someone who's able to collaborate, because as a marketer, you're actually influencing stakeholders to direct a brand a certain direction. You don't do all the work yourself, but you must be able to bring everyone together so that the work happens.
Okay.
I have to echo what Lungi said, actually. It's someone who's inquisitive by nature, and I think my second point is someone who has real empathy. So you have to acknowledge that in the community that we serve, especially for SASKO, I mean, we've got quite a big market in which we serve, but I did not grow up as most other South Africans did. So I need to be able to put myself in the shoes of many other South Africans to understand what you know, what what makes them tick, you know, what they would find appealing and what they need. And, yeah. and so we need to actually develop our mixes and our communication in such a manner that we truly understand what it is that the community in which we serve would want us to do and say and how they would like us to speak to them.
Okay, well, I think I now need to ask you, how are you guys? What are the projects you're currently involved with? Because it was SASKO,
yeah.
you guys are pioneering quite a big number of projects to impact the community.
So,
let's stop it again.
Well, there's a fantastic project which we run called CS Designer. I think last time we spoke about it as well, Zoe. CS Designer stands for We Are Helping Each Other. And so SASKO really partners with daycares, whereby we speak to daycare owners, and we really incentivize them to collect SASKO bread bags. And the more bread bags you collect, the more we reward and incentivize through delivery of whatever your daycare needs. It may be tables and chairs and cooking facilities. And that's one way in which, you know, SASKO makes a difference in community. But it always warms my heart to actually go into these daycares to see the next generation coming, you know, coming through, and, yeah. and just to be able to actually partner and just make a real difference in communities. It's the most special project for me.
That's very incredible. And Lungi, for you?
And for me, it's also as the SASKO brand belongs in a company called Pioneer Food, so we're part of yeah. a bigger corporate that shares exactly the same values as this brand. I mean, we have a student program where we sponsor students that go into varsity, and being able to be part of a business that does that work of mentoring and making sure that students go into corporate and see things and they're mentored along their path is quite valuable. We get involved in these projects and being able to mentor other students before they even come out of varsity.
Yeah, sure. That's absolutely incredible. Well, ladies, thank you so much for joining us this morning and for sharing some insights into your journey. And there you go, ladies. Go out there and take over the world like Lungi and Leanne. And to those that are already moving and shaking it up, why not start mentioning and mentoring the next generation of powerful women?
Yeah. SASKO, baking together since 1930.
Powerful women all around in the studio this morning. It's so inspiring to have around us. And, you know, they're just so inspiring, showing us that they can actually achieve a balance of happiness in the workplace and in their lives, right? Because when you're happy at work, you're happy in real life. And that's why we're going to be talking about a work-life balance later on in the show.
Yeah, it should be one and the same thing. Then I'm going to hop back into the kitchen and attempt a bulletproof mocha. Is it indeed bulletproof? I will put it to the test. We'll see you now.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Welcome back to your feel-good breakfast show. I just asked them, do you want to bring us in? And he was like,
Friday.
No. I'm like, just bring us in. It is a happy Friday. Tabiso, how are you feeling after your first week back?
I must tell you, it started off a bit overwhelming. And now everyone's been so nice and warm and welcoming. And it's really good. I feel like I've made a new family here, which is really awesome. Man. You've been
a new
amazing.
Family. Well, listen, it's great having you here. Let's find out what's happening with our international stars for entertainment news.
Yeah. Kind of local, kind of international, all mashed into one. Now, on Wednesday, we announced that Bonang Matheba will be the host of the Women in Media conference taking place in Johannesburg in September. September. Well, scandal has dawned on the event as Taraji P. Henson has denied that she'll be part of it at all. Or should we say that she has denied that she even knew about the event at all. That's what she said on social media. So the social media post announcing that she'll be a speaker at the event has since been deleted. And the organizers of the event, 21st Century Group, claimed that Henson, along with international stars Halle Berry and Ashanti, would be attending the conference, which will take place at the Sandton Convention Center in Johannesburg on the 5th of September. Mm. Now, in a series of tweets, Henson denied that she would be on the panel, adding that she had never heard of it. Actress Halle Berry's name has also been removed from the official lineup of the International Women in Media website. And yesterday, the story evolved even further, where organizers, the 21st Century Group, finally spoke out. And this is what they had to say. According to the statement, they are in possession of three contracts, proof of payment and direct emails between 21st Media Group, Superstar Agency, and 42 West PR. Adding, and they said this, a deposit was also paid to Superstar Agency as a matter of enforcing and complying with said contract. The matter has now been handed over to the company's New York legal team to determine whether the blunder was due to miscommunication or deliberate breach of contract. And now on the local spectrum, Bonang Matheba has also announced that she will be withdrawing from the conference totally, saying she received no feedback or clarity on the matter. So now, I guess, how can the event...
A mess.
It's a whole mess.
How do you recover from that? Because if you're paying for a business class ticket, no one's going to be satisfied sitting in economy. And that's what's basically happening here. It's false advertising.
Wow. What a way to just break it down. And I understand completely now.
Legally they'll sort everything out because they said they are in possession of contracts. Yeah. But if it is false accusations, it was false advertising.
Yeah. The thing is for me is that we live in 2018, so social media is a big thing, is a real thing. If you're going to announce that Taraji P. Henson is coming to the country, she's got fans in the country, obviously. So they're going to tag her. They're going to say, can't wait to see you.
Exactly.
And so if you were lying, then it's a problem, because how would you think she'll never know?
The truth will come out.
If there are contracts and EFT and SMSs that were quing, quing, there's going to be trouble. Well, that's the latest international entertainment news.
It is tough. It is tough out there. And maybe you need some help finding some balance between work and, you know, your personal life and your balanced life. Mm. We've got you sorted. Leanne's in the lounge.
Let's face it, some days life can be hectic, and every now and then we all have our moments of feeling overwhelmed by the amount of things we need to get done. The good news is that there's one less thing you need to worry about when it comes to breakfast. Now, Jungle Oats Instant is a great solution for breakfast on those busy mornings and is available in a variety of flavors that might just brighten up your day. It's made from 100% whole grain oats. Jungle Oats Instant is low in GI, assists with heart wellness, and is high in fiber, which will leave you feeling fuller for longer on those days when you just need to keep going. Now, here to give us a few life lessons is clinical psychologist Asha Dulab. So good to have you on the show this morning.
Thank you so much for having me.
I think we're all in this whole vibe of wanting to live a healthier and more balanced work life and just like personal life in general. Asha, how do we get that right?
Well, first and foremost, I think we all have different roles to play in our lives. It's different roles that make up a sense of ourselves. And what's very important is that we see these roles as equal. We all need to respect these roles, see them as relevant, and see them as important in our life. The minute we feel that one role is more important than the other, we go out of balance. So see, have a mindset of equanimity, equal-mindedness.
Exactly.
In order to maintain that balance. Mm.
But I love your whole vibe. It's just so so balanced. I absolutely love it. Now, we are approaching exam season. It's a very stressful times for a lot of learners out there. Mm-hmm. How can parents help their kids stay more balanced, especially when it comes to exam stress?
Well, first and foremost, the parents need to be relaxed and calm themselves.
That would help.
I'll never forget having a five-year-old come and see me for a session once, and she sat down and she said to me, I'm stressed.
Excuse me, how old?
Five-year-old. Five-year-old.
Wow.
And when the mom came into the office and she mimicked the exact same behavior, she sat down and she also said, I'm stressed. So it really starts off with us as parents to be relaxed, to maintain a healthy, relaxed home environment. Mm. Sleep is very important. Maintaining a good sleep ritual for both adults and children.
Yeah.
And our emotions are very important.
Exactly.
Maintaining good relationships with people.
Yeah.
And in doing that, I mean, going back to sleep, we have to be able to have deep, restful sleep.
Yeah.
At least up to 6 to 8 hours a day. And many of us are not getting that today.
Exactly.
We need to have a bit of digital fasting, if I can call it, digital detox. Because we're quite overstimulated.
Yeah, 100%. And I think nutrition also plays a huge role in that, because we tend to consume a lot of sugar because we're staying up later so that we can, you know, just load our brains with more information. And that's not a good
Absolutely,
thing.
Absolutely, yes, yes, yes.
Okay. And then what advice can you give our viewers at home who want to maintain a kind of a zest for life? What advice can you give us to maintain that?
Sure. I want to say, let's focus on us being a human being.
Yeah.
I think we are all doers. We're doing all our, every single day. We're just so busy doing that we need to go back to just focus on being with a capital B.
Exactly.
And taking the time to pause, taking the time to connect with people, really developing our existence, feeling alive, developing a sense of awareness on a conscious level.
Yeah.
And experiencing bliss. And in trying to do that, we need to ask ourselves, what gives us joy in life? Mm. What is our true passion? Who are we?
Yeah.
We need to ask those questions to really, really look at balance and zest in life.
Yeah. And I find that sometimes what we put into our body is equally as important as well. Getting outside, taking a good walk, eating a healthy, nutritious, meals during the day, that all adds up to our inner well-being as well.
That's it. Connecting with nature, taking time to be free.
Yeah.
As adults, I think we're so much in that irresponsible role. We're very much in a reactive mode quite often. And rather be more in a reflective mode than a reactive mode.
Yeah.
So, and just embracing our free child.
Exactly. There's nothing wrong with putting yourself first every now and then.
Absolutely. Self-care is most important.
Self-care is most important. Well, there we have it. Work and life balance means different things to different people. But remember that overdoing the work side of life can harm your health and overall happiness. So if you're feeling a little bit off kilter, start by making small changes today to improve your sense of happiness and overall well-being.
South Africa's original oat champion now has a range of nutritious, delicious muesli. New Jungle Muesli, available in an exciting variety of flavors.
All right, does your day need a kickstart? How about a bulletproof kickstart? Are you feeling the ghee?
Yes.
We've got it right there. It's time to hashtag try it hot.
Take a moment between the madness to just chill with Super M, made with love by Clover.
Well, from juggling work and work life and pleasure, there's always a coffee involved, at least as far as we're concerned. So if this is your first time hearing about Bulletproof Coffee, then you're in for a real treat. Now, Bulletproof Coffee is not your average latte. It's a high-performance drink that has a massive impact on your energy levels and your cognitive functioning as well. And we're giving it a Super M hashtag try it hot twist this morning with a mocha.
It's a mocha,
mocha,
the chocolate obviously coming in the form of our chocolate Super M.
Yes.
Which we are hashtag trying it hot right now. We've been doing all sorts of cool hot chocolates kind of mixes. It's warm, you don't want it too hot. But we've got one power espresso.
Mm-hmm.
And the coffee, the caffeine is obviously a part of that bulletproof nature of our coffee. But this is something I think we both encounter during different training methods, often seeing our trainers doing this when they've got to get a boost to cognitive process, but a massive kick on the energy front. So you're going to stir that in with our multicolored whisk. Beautiful stuff. And at least this way, it is going to taste lovely. It's a bit of a strange mix to wrap your mind and your sensory kind of perception around. So you're going to pour that beautiful, lovely, warm mocha mix into our display mugs.
If you will.
And I'm glad we've gone with the glass here because you're going to see an interesting effect. So, it's for the Instagram, Brew. It's for the Instagram.
You've got to have the
creativity.
All right, cool. So there we go.
All right.
Now comes the kicker, right?
So this is the interesting part. So we've got some clarified. Let me clarify it. It's clarified butter.
Excuse me. I just need a little cloth just to make sure. Clarified butter.
So that's what we're saying. So basically, we've broken it down and separated. The butter has separated. It has been clarified. So you're going to just put a teaspoon in, and this is why you need it to be relatively hot. This you'll do right before you drink it or serve it to someone that you care about.
Okay, there we go.
It will separate what you want to see happen, because you want your body to see and know that you're taking this nutrient. All right, that's not official. That's not scientific. I'm just kind of
going with it.
Shmeshmeing.
All right, cool.
And then we've gotten, this is something that we use so often in healthy concoctions. It is our coconut oil.
Oil.
I know you get coconut butter as well. Unbelievable range of healthy benefits. But of course, as an energy source, it is incredibly cool, and it's got. We know that kind of antibacterial, antifungal properties as well, so it really is one of those super foods. I'm going to grab this. The keyword, if you would like to make this bulletproof coffee yourself, is clover. It's
message 3372.
Okay, yeah. So what I like to do, because there is that separation that happens, is to give it a good whip, right?
You're creating almost like a mochaccino.
Yeah, and you almost want to drink it in that tornado state, I call it. So whilst that coconut butter oil and the ghee is at the bottom, then you take a quick sip. You ready?
I'm going to do
One, two, three.
Go for it.
Well, hello there. That's rather...
I can feel my cognitive process.
What?
Just boom, bam. So the keyword again, and that mouthfeel.
Even my jacket wanted some, it spilled all over.
Developing new linguistic capabilities through that. The keyword is clover 233728. It is actually delicious, but let's see how we made it.
I love it.
Cool, man.
It's really cool. Cool.
If you love a good cup of coffee and chocolate, then this recipe is for you. Hashtag try it hot with Clover Super M Bulletproof Mocha. It's a high-performance drink that'll have a massive impact on your energy, and we're giving it a Super M twist. For this recipe, you'll need 300ml Clover Super M chocolate flavored, 2 shots of strong espresso, 2 teaspoons ghee, and 2 teaspoons coconut oil. Pour your Clover Super M chocolate flavor into a pot. Bring to a boil. Then add the espresso. Stir well to combine. Pour into serving glasses. Add a teaspoon of coconut oil and a teaspoon of ghee. Ladies and gentlemen, this is not your average cuppa. Just chill and enjoy the delicious flavor of Clover Super M with this bulletproof mocha.
Made with love by Clover.
Bulletproof. Between the madness. It's really, really cool. Interesting mouthfeel, as we've said, but it's delicious and it is supercharged with nutrients. And that keyword again is clover. It's 33728. Hashtag try it hot.
I am pleasantly surprised.
Take a moment between the madness to just chill with Super M, made with love by Clover.
Well, I hope you're getting that feel-good Friday charge up. Rocco de Villiers is in the building, and after the break, he will be performing for us his Kortbroek en Langkouser.
Ooh, en kijk wie is terug in die atelier, Gert-Johan Coetzee. He's back, and he's introducing us to his brand new kids line. Oh, you do not want to miss a thing on your feel-good breakfast show. We'll see you in just a bit.
Expresso gets comfortable in style as we bring Currycraft's famous line of home furniture into your living room and one step closer to you every morning right here on Expresso. Fully customizable quality, exceptional value and proudly South African in your choice of fabric or leather. That's Currycraft coming to you on Expresso.
Thank you.
Welcome back. It's a Friday morning. Yes, your feel-good breakfast show is live, large, and in charge. We've got to work that out, bro.
In motion,
we've got to work that out, you know?
Let's come back. Let's try and find harmony in it.
Well, let's do this.
Welcome back to the news.
Thank you, gentlemen. Let's take a final look at your national headlines. President Cyril Ramaphosa has announced that a national gender summit will be held on 31 August to deal with issues of gender-based violence. Ramaphosa delivered the keynote address at the National Women's Day celebrations in Paarl yesterday morning. He called for a moment's silence to remember women who have been brutalized and exploited. He told the thousands attending the event in Bakweni and Paarl that men should hang their heads in shame. And he said women should feel protected whether they are on the streets, on village pathways, at work, or just going about their daily lives. And meanwhile, in Johannesburg later yesterday morning, just yesterday, President Ramaphosa said that SA government would not allow land grabs and anarchy in the process of finding a solution for land issue. He was speaking at a conference attended by investors who had expressed an interest in the SA government's efforts to attract new foreign direct investment of $100 million over the next 5 years. Ramaphosa said the land issue will be addressed in such a way that the outcome is good for all in South Africa. Now moving to news abroad, some dozen writers from African and Middle East countries hoping to attend a book festival in Scotland this weekend have had their visa applications refused. This is according to the event organisers. Now Edinburgh International Book Festival Director, that's Nick Barley, he said that although he realises it's systematic, it is a very serious matter. The festival organisers haven't named the authors in question. But at last month's WOMAD Festival, at least three African acts on the bill were unable to perform due to visa complications with British immigration. Now lastly, Argentina senators yesterday voted against legalization of abortion in the homeland of Pope Francis, dashing the hopes of women's rights groups after the bill was approved by the legislature's lower house. The vote was 38 against, 31 in favor, with two abstentions, capping a marathon session that began the day before and stretched into the early hours of yesterday. The vote followed a referendum in Ireland, another traditional Catholic country, that was in May, and it paved the way to legislate for the termination of fetus scissors. And that's where we leave your morning headlines. Let's take a final look at your sport.
Let's kick it off with cricket getting set to conclude the Proteas tour of Sri Lanka with a once-off T20 next Tuesday. Sri Lankan captain Dinesh Chandimal is back in the fold after serving his international ban for refusing to take the field during their test series against the West Indies relating to accusations of ball tampering. He's in the 15-man squad for the shortest format but not for Sunday's final ODI. And with the series at 3-1, the Proteas will again be led by Quinton de Kock in the absence of injured Faf du Plessis before JP Germany steps in on Tuesday. And in local football, ahead of a brief break for the weekend, last night's only fixture in the PSL gave us four goals as Highlands Park drew 2-2 with Black Leopards. Lucky boy McQuena got Highlands off the mark from range in a night that really tested Leopards' diminutive shot stopper Roshitswa Muleka. While Bevan Brunsman was marshalling a pretty solid defence, Highlands let Leopards back in the game in the second. The league resumes next Tuesday at 7:30 in the evening with a spirited Baraka up against a pretty tentative Chiefs early in the season. Then a little further afield, just in time to get us excited at the return of European football, UEFA have released their shortlist for their cream of the crop of last season. Liverpool's Mo Salah joins the usual suspects Ronaldo and Messi for best forward. Last year's winner, now in Italy, of course, Ronaldo a shoe-in with his 15 goals for the reigning European champions. Salah had a pretty remarkable run to the finals with 10 goals and Messi's in there with 6. Then best defender sees Marcelo up against Sergio Ramos and Rafael Varane. And in the midfield, Kevin De Bruyne features alongside Real's duo of Toni Kroos and Luka Modric. And then the winners, of course, will be announced at the end of this month on the 30th of August in Monaco at that group stage draw. And then finally, our wait is over for the English Premier League, and albeit quieter than normal in yesterday's Premier League transfer deadline, moved forward to the day before today's season start for the first time. Move of the day was Colombian World Cup star Yerry Mina signing to Everton from Barcelona. So the Toffees also landed Barca's Andre Gomes and Brazilian winger Bernard. But I think the most publicised disappointment of the day had to be Jose Mourinho, still unable to find a credible centre-back. We'll see if there are any notable holes in the defence to be plugged as Man United get the league underway at Old Trafford tonight at 9 up against Leicester City. And that's a wrap of your sport for this Friday morning.
Don't fear the flu. Boost your immune system with Everflu C Immune Booster by Pharmadynamics. Effective, affordable healthcare.
I hope you're keeping nice and warm, South Africa. A final look at your traffic this morning. Polokwane, a low of 8 and highs of 24. Mbombela, 11 and 28. Pretoria, 4 and highs of 20. Johannesburg, 1 and 18. Mahikeng, minus 1 and 17. Klerksdorp, 0 and 17. Kimberley, 0 and 13. Bloemfontein, lows of minus 4 and highs of 12. Richards Bay, it's rainy there, 11 and 22. Pietermaritzburg, 4 and 20. Durban, 14 and 22. Mthatha, 5 and 14. East London, rainy at lows of 9 and highs of 14. Craydock, minus 1 and high of 11. PE, 7 and 14. For George, 6 and 13. Sutherland, minus 2 and high of 8. Cape Town, 6 and 16. Worcester at minus, sorry, at rather 2 and highs of 14. Springbok, 3 and 12, with Appington at minus 1 and a high of 15. That's it for this morning.
Happy birthday, a very happy birthday to you.
I love it. That tune doesn't bring a smile to your dial. Nothing will. Every day, millions, of course, celebrating their birthdays all over the world. So as we welcome in today, the 10th of August, let's take a moment to celebrate with some of those famous faces, and most importantly, you at
home, hopefully. Yeah, well, if it's your birthday today, you're also sharing it with the one and only Kylie Jenner, who turns, can you believe it, only 21 years old today. I mean, she's known for being part of the Kardashian family and keeping up with the Kardashians, and she has her own cosmetic company, Kylie Cosmetics, which was also made a lot of headlines earlier this year as being the youngest millionaire and, in fact, self-made billionaire soon by Forbes magazine.
Crazy. And then a man who I'm sure has a pretty favorable bank account as well, and he is a legend, Spanish actor, Antonio Banderas. He turns 58 today, known for, I mean, some unbelievable roles. Desperado, one of the coolest masks of Zorro, was amazing. And of course, voicing the iconic character Puss in Boots in the Shrek sequel.
But we can't just wish the celebs. We have to wish you, the celeb in all of this.
Yeah.
So we want to wish a very happy birthday to Wanda Shawzy, who's turning 21 today.
Oh, cool, man.
Happy
Congrats, dude.
Also to Joseph Gensel, who's turning 56. We're wishing Kevin Hunter, who is celebrating his first birthday today, a happy birthday. And then also we want to wish Zorza a happy birthday. She's turning 31 years old. Absolutely gorgeous. Have a fantastic birthday.
Oh man, that's our bite-sized dose of birthdays today. Thank you so much for sharing with us. Please connect with us if it's your birthday coming up, or maybe you want to nominate your gorgeous little one. Hit us up at Expresso Show is the handle to use.
All right, it's time for some music on this Friday morning, and Rocco de Villiers joins us. He's launched his 14th studio album. 14th, yes, a whole 10 plus 4. And he's about to perform the title track to the album called Kortbroek Lankouse.
Thank you.
Welcome back. This is your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Thanks so much for starting this Friday morning off with us. Now, for anyone with an appetite for iconic urban fashion, McDonald's have partnered with South Africa's fashion designer to the stars, Gert-Johan Coetzee, to create a range of tasty streetwear inspired by the Big Mac on its 50th birthday that'll see all the proceeds being donated to the Ronald McDonald House charity. And it's great to have the man himself, ladies and gentlemen, Gert-Johan Coetzee in the studio.
Thank you so much.
Deserving of the ancestral ululation.
Thank you, I love it.
Yeah. Listen, what we love is the work that you are doing, the fact that you have partnered up with McDonald's and you've produced this range and the proceeds are going to a charitable cause. Yeah. But tell me first about how this all came about, and especially right now, that you are doing a kids' range. Because we saw the initial range that you produced, and now you've gone into designing for kids. How was that experience?
I think fashion with a conscience or fashion with a purpose has always been what I'm about. Yeah. I love using my platform for the greater good. So when McDonald's and I collaborated, it just made complete sense that we make such a hoo-ha of it. And designing a kids range for the first time was a lot of fun. But kind of the trends of the day led what I was going to design for the kids range because the big trend at the moment is twinning. So you see a lot of the grown-up range in the kiddies range. So they're kind of inspired by each other. And it's so cute and it's so adorable, especially the little onesie that we made. It is just was a blast designing.
I can't wait to see it. And, but of course, your portfolio is made up of stars. The red carpets that your garments have seen are incredible. So, but now this is a bit of a different start because this is streetwear, street style. Chilled, you know, things like swag start coming into play here. Is this something that you're looking to dabble in?
So for the last 3 or 4 seasons, we have been dabbling a lot into like streetwear, you know, like couture for the street. So it's really much of the Gert and Coetzee glitz and glamour, just more everyday wear.
Yeah.
And it's great because that is where the trends are at and that is what girls are wearing at the moment.
Yeah. And I mean, it's incredible, as I said in the beginning, the fact that this is all going to the Ronald McDonald House charity. Tell me about the organization and exactly what it is that they do.
It is a non-profit organization that kind of creates housing or short-term housing for parents of sick children.
Okay.
So I think when you are in that situation where your child is sick, the last thing that you have to worry about or want to stress about is getting back and forth to the hospital. And the Ronald McDonald House Charity kind of like bridges that gap and creates housing or like a hostel service almost for these parents.
And we're looking at some of the visuals
it's
there.
It's beautiful.
That is incredible too.
And you know, it's a nice place to go to and you find support there and it's just a great charity and it's so needed and it's something that so many people look past.
Yeah.
And it's at the Baragwanath Hospital and also at the Nelson Mandela Hospital.
That's wonderful. And you think about those families that, you know, when you do go home to a place like that, and though it may be temporary, it offers a lot of relief mentally, emotionally for the family.
Especially if you don't have to travel. And the abandonment rate from mothers with new children has gone from 40% to 0% since they've started this charity. So it is amazing. So it's really the proof is in the pudding. It's working. And all the proceeds of this collection is going to those houses to make it bigger and better and perhaps open up more in the future.
That is incredible, man. I'm just wondering, like, someone like you probably have no time to do a lot of the stuff that you actually have to do to keep your business running. Why is this so important to you? I know you mentioned before that, you know, fashion with a purpose or fashion for a cause is what drives you, but why is this so important to you?
I feel I was very lucky to be given this platform that I have in South Africa and Africa at such a young age, and it would be selfish of me to keep it for myself and not share it. So I think also my philosophy of charity is it's really the smallest little things you can do to help. And anybody can do charity anywhere. I mean, by supporting, donating a £5 here, buying a garment there, all of these type of things is a small way for you to add in the whole basket of making South Africa better.
Absolutely. And no matter how big, no matter how small that donation may be, it makes a difference. Because if all of us do it, then we make that big difference.
Right.
Yeah. Now, I want to see the new range, okay? And
let's
you brought some of the pieces
with
you. All right, let's have a look. Bring on the models. let's have a look at our first. Oh, hello. Hi. All right, take us through this piece.
So this is the little onesie. I think it's great. it looks adorable. It's got a little detail at the back here on the hoodie, which is adorable. And then if you'll just flip your t-shirt, what I love about the t-shirt is that it's a flip t-shirt. So because it's the Big Mac 50th, we had to bring a cute little burger in there. So you can mix and match it. If you want to wear all white with a burger on your chest, you can, but you can also take it back down and really look pop iconography with just the golden arch.
That is super cool if I've ever seen it. All right, let's bring on the next model. What we got? Ah, hashtag twinning.
See what I mean? So this is really the trend of the day. Mommy and daughter or sisters really just twinning and rocking this up. Gert-Johan is known for tutu, so what would a children's range be without a tutu? Yeah. And then it's embellished with lots of golden studs and of course lots of golden arches just to bring that really iconic look through.
I really love this top.
Thank you, and what I love about these tops is you can really just tie them up at the back.
Yeah, like
make it a bit of a crop. Like I like to sometimes take a hairband and just tie it at the back. You know, it's really about exploring fashion. I mean, we design these things for you, but it is up to you to really bring across your personal style through
it. It's such a statement piece. Lovely ladies, you're looking amazing. Let's have the next model, please. Oh, say what?
You know.
No, Gert, no. Now you're killing people out there. Now you're doing it right now, man. Look at you right now.
So these are actually our best sellers at the moment on the online store. I think really big trend at the moment is this kind of like frill, almost like bordering your shoulders, which I really love about it. Mixing satin with like such something as luxurious as satin and crystals with a bit of like a t-shirting vibe, a tracksuiting, is a nice juxtaposition, and I really love the way it comes out, and it's very comfortable to wear. And of course, you've got your iconic golden arch on your t-shirt right there. And again, I kind of like when I designed this, I made everything kind of boyfriend cuts so that it is meant to be oversized, it's meant to look relaxed, it's meant to look super cool. And you can dress this up and down with heels or sneakers, whatever way you want.
I didn't, just turn around there with the golden track, you don't want to see the back of it. That is stunning.
All crystallized and studded.
Well done, man, well done. Do another piece?
I do.
I could do this all day long. All right, bring on the next piece, please. Oh, now we're just dripping in finesse.
So this is
beautiful.
This is our quilted boyfriend jacket. This is unisex. And also with this McDonald's range was the first time I did menswear. So this is actually a menswear jacket. And instead of crystals, we put some nice manly studs on there. This is a classic Gert-Johan Coetzee little glamorous dress. I think Gert-Johan Coetzee is all about glitz and glamour. And this is a great combination of it. And I love pairing it with the sneakers because it just makes it so much cooler.
Wow, absolutely stunning, absolutely stunning. All right, I believe we have more.
Can yeah, we do.
Yes, there's
we have
more.
We have more.
It's like McDonald's fries. I always want more. Give me more. Okay.
So this is one of our couture pieces in the collection. So this is maybe our most glamorous jacket in the collection. It's called the tinsel jacket. It is really for a night out. That glamorous Insta girl that always needs to be popping. This is exactly made for her. And what I like about this trend is crop tops are massive at the moment, and it's really great to wear it with tracksuit. But if you do not have the confidence to really show your stomach, it's great also with a bodysuit inside. Or sometimes what I do is I pair it with a crisp white shirt and then the crop top over it, and that just really pulls the look together well.
Yeah. Listen, I'm loving the statement pieces, the jacket before and this as well. Like you say, depending on the event you're going to, your Instagram boomerangs will be popping for days.
And when I design in general, I always have the Insta girl in mind. So it's really for those girls that knows how to work the gram and knows how to work her angles.
All right, I think that is it. Oh, we have one more.
We
have one more. Oh, hello, Nana. This is beautiful.
So this is just a shorter version of the tutu, and I really love wearing it with leggings or with denims like this. And the little black jacket that she has on, that's a part of a twinning set, so there is a grown-up unisex jacket, tracksuit for mommy and daddy to wear, so the whole family can be rocking those golden arches with McDonald's.
That is so cool, man. Oh man, thank absolutely you. Love it. Well done to all our models. I feel like we should have that last grand walk where
the
they
Paris
do it
walk.
Together.
That would
but
be
it's
great.
Okay. No, we didn't rehearse that. but so where can people shop the look?
So you can shop the look at shopgert.com. The online store has been up for about 3 months now.
Yeah.
And you can just go and peruse through there and see what we've got for you. There's many more things. I only brought some of the pieces.
Oh, wow.
And like I said, there are lots of men's stuff as well. So have a look out at shopgert.com.
Excellent. Shopgert.com. Type that into your browser and go out and check out this fashion with a cause, fashion with a purpose. And I hope that this is a partnership that continues for many, many years to come. I know that it's especially now for the Big Mac's 50th birthday, but this is really, really some really cool stuff.
We've and got many things in the pipeline coming up, so keep your eyes on the gram.
Nice one. Gert-Johan Coetzee, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, how exciting.
That was really, really awesome. I like all those looks. But listen, the So You Think You Can Shop competition at Blue Route Mall is well into its first round. And this Saturday, be sure to stop by and watch as the 10 finalists compete for a brand new Kia Picanto.
It's super exciting. You know what? The contestants, they'll need to be motivated by keeping their hand placed on the car. And this was the last contestant standing. That's the one that gets to drive off in their brand new wheels. And to enter and stand a chance to win, to be a contestant in the second round of the competition, all you need to do is head on over to Blue Route Mall, spend 250 Rand or more, and you'll be entered into the second grand finale.
But wait, there's more. That's not all. Viewers and shoppers can also enter into a Facebook competition for a chance to win a variety of fabulous and exciting prizes. And the competition closes on the 26th of August. T's and C's apply.
Man, I'm loving watching the proud parents milling about. Oh, they are so sweet. Well done to all of our young models. We're going to take the quickest of breaks. Then Nick Strelitz is back. It's time for our fashion fix on Vogue and always on time. Then we're going to enjoy some of those magical moments provided by our Dipper Omar Wall of Fame. We'll see you now.
Enjoy a moment in between with McAfee. See you after the break.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Oh, welcome back to your feel-good breakfast show. And it's Friday on your feel-good breakfast show, which can mean only one thing. It's the fashion fix. It's on Vogue and on time. And it's your weekly destination for curated news that you can use. And also a roundup of everything you need to know to kick off your weekend in dripping style. And here with the scoop, we have Expresso's fashion editor, Nick Strelitz. And joining us is also a very, very special guest, fashion designer, Gert-Johan Coetzee. Good morning.
So nice to have you here. This is such a moment.
The fashionista is on one couch.
Oh, you are too kind. You look good yourself, girl. You're looking good.
Thank you so much. Welcome. Listen, Nick, give us the scoop on what's happening with terms of trends in the international sphere.
Yes. Now listen, guys, we've talked about this earlier in the week, but I don't care because it's iconic. We have to reiterate, Beyonce's Vogue cover for the September issue.
Mm-hmm.
Come on. I mean, can we get a round of applause for Beyonce? Yeah. Let's just hit it for Beyonce. Now, so this is an iconic moment, guys, not just for Beyonce, but for persons of color, for black women, particularly in the fashion entertainment industry. Beyonce even being very candid in her interview, saying when she was on the up, she was told by industry experts she would never be on the front covers of magazines like Vogue.
Now what?
But listen, it's been 53 years since the first supermodel, Danielle Luna, graced the cover of Harper's Bazaar in 1965. That was the first time a person of color, black woman, was allowed on the front cover of a major publication. So we've come a long way. There's still so much more to go. Mm. But if we look at the September issues this year, which is the most coveted issue of the year, Black Girl Magic is shining big. We have people like Rihanna and Beyonce, which we talked about.
Riri, yes.
Riri, the first black woman in 102 years of British Vogue.
I can't even, and I'm obsessed with those thin eyebrows.
I have those, you should see me last year.
Because last week you rocked the thin eyebrows.
I debuted a skinny eyebrow.
Gert-Johan Coetzee, what do you think of those skinny eyebrows?
I love the trends. I love the skinny eyebrow. I don't see it catching on though, but it looks quite trendy. But the theme that I see going across all these magazines for the September issue is the flower headdress, the crown.
Yes.
That is very important. I'm just obsessed with that. And I think it's something South African girls can adopt and just rock.
Absolutely. I mean, there's people also like Lupita Nyong'o, who's on the cover of Porter as well.
Oh.
We're seeing Slick Woods, who's one of Rihanna's muses, on the cover of LUK.
Is she pregnant?
She's pregnant. Zoe. She ain't fat, girl. She pregnant.
Listen, I don't judge a girl.
No, we don't.
Daily,
let's go.
Expecting.
Yeah.
Okay.
And Zendaya as well, who's the current It Girl, on the cover of Marie Claire. Tracee Ellis Ross, Elle Canada. So it's a huge, huge moment for black women celebrating that black girl magic. It's incredible.
Well,
it's
we
a moment.
Can celebrate a lot of Mzanzi's black girl magic.
Yes.
And I know there's been some fabulous collaborations with Gert-Johan Coetzee and some of our leading ladies. So
yes.
Nick, you're going to take us through some of those iconic looks.
Yeah, let's take you down a trip down memory lane for
Ooh.
You. Let's pick some incredible moments.
Looks.
So
Yay.
First, Miss Minnie Dlamini, of course, at her wedding last year, right?
Wow, guys.
Tell us about this.
This was amazing. Minnie came to me and she's like, Gert, I want the wedding dress of the century. What do we need? And I was like, volume, volume, volume.
Yes.
That dress took 150 meters of tulle to make.
Whoa.
Oh my gosh.
It had 3D printing on it, these flowers coming up, these lilies. These lilies is Minnie's favorite flower, and they were 3D printed. And then all of that was adorned with Swarovski crystals.
Oh my God, no big deal.
Goosebumps,
It's insane.
Incredible.
It took us about a year to make that dress.
Insane.
It's crazy. Of course, the African Khaleesi, Miss Pearl Tusi at the 2015 Metro FM Music Awards.
Wow. That dress we had to make in such a short time. You know, with schedules always, and that was, I think, my first or second time working with Pearl.
Okay.
So you're not so sure of her body yet.
Right.
So it was an amazing collaboration. I'm so happy that it came out so well.
Yeah.
And it was a classic kind of nod to our old Hollywood style.
Very classic.
This is a classic, and it looks like it was literally
painted on her body.
On her perfect body.
Okay, this is one of my favorites. I can't be partial. This dress, when I saw this came out, I literally took four laps around the block. But now, of course, at her 30th birthday
You know,
bash.
When we're going to shut things down, we're going to shut things down, especially when it comes to Instagram. And this is what we wanted to do for this dress. And it was Bonang's 30th birthday.
Yeah.
And she has worn every single style there is.
Yeah.
So what was left then a big, big, massive frilly
bulge. I love it.
You have to reveal how much material did it take to make that dress.
We really make a dress under 150 meters of fabric.
Jeez, that's
insane. Yep.
That's
and remember, the fabric is 3 meters wide as well. So it's even extra. It's really extra.
She looked incredible.
The whole event was so beautiful. It was like a wedding.
Where was my invite, Banas?
Oh,
next
beautiful.
Year. And then, of course, Kelly Rowland. We're throwing it back to 2013. I saw Kelly Rowland wore one of your pieces as well to an event. I mean, this is...
Kelly Rowland. That was such a fun day. Like, I basically got invited to a friend's birthday party, and Kelly was there, and I knew, so I quickly made her a dress. Not quickly, it took a while. I made the dress, gave it to her, and she was so lovely, and she wore it, and she tagged me on Instagram, and that was one of my big launches into the international fashion market was through her post, because she made about 4 posts on her Instagram. That was so
That's
nice.
That's huge. Oh. Absolutely huge.
Well, listen,
love it.
I'm loving this fashion chat. I would love to chat the whole day with the
me
two
too.
Of you, but Gert, thank you so much for joining us
thank
this
you,
morning.
Guys.
Thank you.
Thank you. And Nick, thank you to you.
Thank
and
you,
I can't think of a better way to wrap up today's edition of the Fashion Fix. And of course, a one last big thank you to Gert-Johan Coetzee for joining us this morning. So make sure you head on over to Expresso Show's Facebook page right now and cast your vote for your favorite Gert-Johan Coetzee creation.
All right. Well, I think you'll have to admit we've had a fantastic winter with our Omar Rusks cozying up and getting to know our guests and how they love to dipper Omar. And so for this very precious moment, if you will, a cozy moment, we thought we'd take a dip down memory lane to take a look at some of our favorite dips.
But it's that time of the morning again where it's hashtag dip a Omar time. And we've been seeing how all of our guests dip a Omar.
It's called the big five dip. The way it works is you take three in the one and two in the other. You do a double dip.
Ew. Bicep grip and dip.
What?
Bam.
And then I go.
I call it the Britney. 3, 2. Oops, I did it again to my Omar Rusk.
I've really given this some thought. It's
okay.
called the grip flip and dip. So while you're flipping, you're dipping.
What are you going to call it, dude?
The Captain America.
in an uncertain future.
Captain America!
I call it the kettlebell dip. The kettlebell dip.
You like to live on the edge of your seat.
So let me
with
take
the
you through it. You're obviously on the edge of your seat.
What?
You're dipping as you go down, and just a little dip.
Jeannie de Yonk. Oh, wow. Why you gotta do it so sexy, though? I can't do it like you.
I wasn't ready, but it's delicious.
Oh, man. Oh, what a time. What a time to be alive. It's been a fantastic journey with Omar Rusks, and we've had an incredible time taking a look at everyone's dip. But this being the very last time that we do this, we couldn't just leave it be because we have a floor executive manager who has FOMO the size of the planet, and he thought he has one more dip for the ages. So please welcome onto our Dipper Wall or Dipper Omar Wall seat, Lucian Albertine, ladies and gentlemen. There he is. Full crew. So Lucian, you have made an executive order that this moment shall happen.
Of course it shall happen.
And now it is happening to all of us to witness the very last hashtag Dipper Omar Dip. All right, so you know how it works. You got to tell us first, what's your favorite flavor of
obviously. Buttermilk.
Yeah, we have to bring
it's
it
out. Here, you know.
There it is. Okay, cool.
And the chunky version, so I like the chunky version.
You like it chunky?
Yes, it's nice and full. Mm.
Yes, it's okay, good. Now, you got to show us your dip, and then you got to give it a name. That's how it works, right?
Cool.
Okay, so here we go.
I'm going to do my dip I'm going to stand up.
Oh my
Camera
God.
One, get ready for this.
Get your cameras ready, get your boomerangs
you know, since
ready.
Everybody has done a singing.
Yes.
Jenny Morris has had your moment. People have been, you know, biceps and triceps. I'm gonna do the dance dip. So,
because he's a well-known choreographer too. All right, so,
so I'm gonna do the guara dip.
The guara dip.
So I'm gonna get my Omar rice.
So you get your rice.
Get ready for position.
Yeah.
And it's supposed to get the momentum going. You know.
And it keeps going. You gotta keep it nice and steady because it dips itself in and out.
It's going. And we bite.
And then you get in there. Oh, okay, the guara dip by Lucian Albertine. There we go. Our very last dip of this wonderful journey. And
me.
I think it's, hey?
Let's do it with me.
Should I do it with you?
Mm-hmm.
For the cameras. But now, see now, here's the problem. He tricked me, because he knows I usually guara with my right, and now he's asking me to guara with my left, and then dip with my right, which is gonna be awkward. Okay, 1, 2, 3.
One, two, three.
Hey, yes, 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 and then just it.
When
you're done at the end. Beautiful stuff. But listen, winter, of course, isn't over yet.
Cozy up this winter and Dipper Omar.
Well, our Friday Fashions is not over yet because we're back with the Style Squad for another edition of Fab or Fail. And this is where we take a look at the week's best and worst and most questionable celebrity fashion. We've got our paddles for yay or nay or fab or fail. Gert-Johan Coetzee is still joining us alongside Nick Strelitz. And this morning we're doing something different. We're going to take a look at the fashion over the last 40 years.
Okay.
Wow. Nick.
Love it.
So let's take a first look. This one, the first one up is multi-talented Cher. And this was at the 1986 Oscars.
Wow, that is an entrance.
Yeah.
Entrance.
Ooh, yes,
you like it.
Yes. I love it, I'm obsessed. You know how many times I've been inspired by this look? From the hairdress to her makeup to just her swag that she had. I still have.
So much confidence. Her face hasn't moved in 75 years, an inch, and we love it. Right? That's why we love her.
And so her body.
So you guys have the fashion expert from normal eyes. I say no. Okay, let's move on to Britney Spears's oops, I did it again moment.
Oh, don't disappoint me.
I love it.
Are you?
I'm loving it.
Okay.
I've always loved this look.
This is incredible. Can I just say I had a Britney Spears themed party 3 years ago? This isn't a lie, and I wore this exact outfit. Didn't have the camel toe, unfortunately. Wish I did. I will show you after
Let's
the show.
It's
guys, that is the outfit that my spirit animal would wear.
Right? Yes, okay. Absolutely.
Britney is a yay.
A yay.
Let's throw it back to the 2001 MTV Music VMAs with Beyonce and Destiny's Child.
I'm so, yeah, I can't. I can't.
I mean, I love like the them, color but combo, no. But that's about it.
Listen, no,
it's horrible. Everything is bad there.
It's bad. They're trying to cover Michelle up with too much fabric. Michelle always getting the rough end of the stick.
Let
Michelle free. But also, you know I love Beyonce. I would step in front of a moving vehicle for this woman, but not in this
outfit.
Okay. So no. Okay. So that's a no. It's an all-rounding no. Yes. Let's move on to First Lady Michelle Obama at the presidential inaugural in 2009.
I mean,
that was an iconic moment.
Right? Yeah. It's incredible. She was wearing actually designer Jason Wu, who was a young American designer, actually Canadian at the time. And she was so prolific and supportive of young designers, which I absolutely loved.
And didn't that launch his career? Because see where he is now. Yeah.
Huge. Absolutely huge.
Huge. And let's move on to one of my favorites, Sarah Jessica Parker at the 2013 Met.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
That headrest, I can.
Would you rock that?
You like that?
It's very similar to the sure one. Like, I can see where the inspiration comes from.
Yeah.
I like that.
Yeah, the theme was punk at the Met Gala this year, and she just balanced it beautifully with elegance. And
that was Alexander McQueen,
and that
right?
Boot.
Yeah, no, Vivienne Westwood.
Vivienne Westwood,
yes,
right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There incredible.
We go, that boot. Okay, and let's go to Rihanna at the Met in 2017.
Yes.
I'm obsessed with Comme des Garçons.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Okay. I feel like, from a normal eye, I want to say this, but okay, from a fashion eye, I see why
put
everyone's loving it.
Put your fashion goggles
it
on. Why did you like this
I'm
so
in between. I like it. I like it, but I don't.
I love it. The theme that year was Comme des Garçons.
Exactly.
And I love just almost the Japanese influence of her hair and makeup. It just yeah, really works with the dress.
Yeah. Rihanna, could you know? I mean, like, this woman is everything.
Yeah.
Everything.
Everything.
And more.
She didn't rock the skinny brow.
She did. Did you like the skinny brow?
I didn't.
Oh, okay. Didn't. So apparently she can't
There's
rock it.
There's a lot of things I don't like, but I'll keep quiet.
Yes. After you say it. And then you keep quiet.
Sometimes silence is golden.
Yes,
thank
absolutely.
You, Nick Strelitz.
Thank you,
Gert. Thank you once again for
Thanks,
joining
guys.
Us for this week's edition of Fab or Fail.
So
you got a little behind the scenes take there as we were trying to decide who was going to do what coming up, okay?
Yeah.
And I've got this one, thankfully, Teresa is going to be making me some hot wings and booty sauce. So happy day. All right, now, let's see if we can get this.
Also, after the break, we have a stunning performance by Rocco de Villiers. He's going to be singing his song, Wat om te dra achter op a baki.
Ooh, yeah! I'm going to give you the gold. It's my feel-good breakfast show. Look at this. It's a cheesy grin. It's a blue cheesy grin. Welcome back. You're live with Expresso. We've got just enough time to squeeze in the rock star of all recipes that we have ever made. Teresa, I love you. Why? Because I love hot wings and I love a blue cheese dipping sauce, and that's exactly what you brought.
Yes.
Is this the coolest recipe you know?
Totally, totally.
Hands
and
down.
It's perfect for your bride this weekend.
I love it. I've even been able to pick some of our flowers from our very own Uber garden here. So,
beautiful.
So looking forward to that. While those soak and rinse off, you get going,
right,
sister.
Let's
what
start
are we doing?
With our sauce. Okay, so we're going to make a spicy tomato sauce to go on our chicken wings. So
yeah.
Start off with a drizzle of olive oil.
Is this, in your box? And maybe I'm being silly, is it peri-peri or is it spicy tomato? Is there a big difference?
What type of spice? It's spicy tomato, so it's a basic tomato sauce, and we're going to add some chili, some paprika, some cayenne pepper.
Oh, nice. Levels of heat.
Totally.
I like that.
And you can add as much or as little as you prefer.
We are so blessed with a range of chilies that are being grown in South Africa all year round.
Totally. So I've just popped our finely diced onion into the pot with some cayenne pepper and some paprika.
The spice is going in quite early, is that important?
Yes, I like cooking them at the beginning just to let them release their flavours and kind of get into the sauce. Totally. So I've also added some garlic and some finely chopped chilli. So just cook that off for about a minute just to get all those flavours going. And then I'm going to add a tin of tomatoes.
Let's say it's quick and easy. So you can chop the tomatoes presumably if you want, but you want a bit of the puree, the sauce element in
there as well. Exactly, exactly. And it's nice and convenient. So add that, and then a little bit of water. And then...
You really can. I love these wrought iron pots that you can throw on the braai as well.
Exactly. Do it all in one spot. Don't forget to season with a bit of salt and pepper. And then you're going to let this simmer for about 15 minutes. So it'll
thicken
just up.
A little bit,
That's right. Once it's been simmering for a while, don't forget to taste it. Check your seasoning, check your levels of heat, and just make sure you're happy with that.
I don't think there's going to be an issue with forgetting to taste where my mouth, it becomes almost incapable. I can become incapable of talking because my mouth is filled with so much moisture because it's just so awesome.
So then once that's done, you can blitz it with a food processor just to break it down a bit and make it nice and smooth.
So you want that sauce to get into every little nook and cranny of your beautiful chicken wings.
Absolutely. And then scoop a little bit out of the bowl and brush it onto your chicken pieces.
Could you do this well in advance? Is it something that you can get away with doing quite quickly?
Absolutely. Make the sauce ahead of time, brush it over your chicken and leave it in the fridge until you're ready to cook it. And then reserve some of the sauce because we're going to use it later as well.
Okay.
So brush a little bit on. I'm going to pop these on the braai. Do you want to start with the blue cheese?
You just tell me what to do.
So we've got the blue cheese in the bowl. We're going to add some sour cream, some garlic, and some mayonnaise.
Some cream mayonnaise.
Just whisk it all
together. Am I putting all of this
in? Throw it all in, yeah.
Cool. And again, we are blessed with some amazing blue cheese variants made locally.
Absolutely.
We always want to try and keep it local, especially with the braai. It's so nice to know where all of the ingredients have come from.
That's right. So you can get some more sauce on this guy.
Of course, impress everyone when you're serving these delicious. And with the whisk, are we going to be mixing it all together?
Yeah. Wow. It doesn't have to be completely smooth, but get as many of the lumps out as you can.
Cool. And a healthy, not the whole jar of garlic, but a healthy portion of garlic going in there.
Right, let's pop these on here.
Oh, yummy.
Smelling good.
Yeah, no, this looks amazing. On this, I mean, this blue cheese combo, the chili spice with a creamy offset, that sounding board.
It really works so well.
This can go with so many different variations.
Yeah.
Okay, this is actually starting to look amazing.
It looks good. So I'm going to put some salt and pepper in there.
Cool. I'm going to keep just softening
it
up.
There we go.
I do it on a hot day. I know that we've been struggling with a bit of cold across the country, sitting here in the Western Cape at the moment. But
this will warm you up.
This will get the muscles going, get the blood going, but a little bit of heat does help with our mixture. Okay, that's looking absolutely amazing.
So basically, you're going to cook your chicken wings over the coals until they're nice and crispy, and then pop them back into the sauce. Keep the sauce warm on the side, toss them in the leftover sauce, and then pop them onto your serving dish, and serve it with your blue cheese dip.
About how long, I know you're dealing with quite small pieces of chicken here, how long do you need to cook them?
It shouldn't take long, 15 minutes, 15, 20 minutes.
And then I'm going to dress
it in, maybe serve it with some wet wipes as well.
I love that, and nice and fresh from our very own garden. This looks absolutely beautiful. I'm going to add one more there. You have outdone yourself. Teresa, thank you so much. The keyword here is, you guessed it, braai, to 33728. You can create these beautiful hot wings and blue cheese dipping sauce yourself. Well done. Booyah.
Tune into Afternoon Express today at 4:30 p.m. for a decadent coffee-based Italian dessert recipe with a twist. Banana affogato topped with creamy vanilla ice cream. Yum! A simple yet delicious end to any meal.
Alrighty then, if you've just joined us, you picked perhaps the most perfect time to tune in. Rocco de Villiers is in the studio. His 14th studio album, Kortbroek Langkose, is now out and available on all digital platforms. Is there a physical copy? Yes, there is a physical copy. I saw one earlier on. What surprised me was a lot of the titles of the songs. We got stuff like Kortbroek Langkose, title snit, Goeie Gevoel, good feeling. But this one,
Wat om te dra achter op een bakkie? What to wear when you are sitting at the back of a bakkie? Please tell me about what inspired that song.
It's a real story. I did a show in a very small town. Then the show sold out. They put me outside in a big hall. They gave me a car to drive to the hall, but they said there's no dressing room. Please put your costume on already. So I was in the middle of the Karoo in a car that they gave me to drive to the big hall in a full-length blue sequin suit.
Wow.
So the car stopped, it failed. So then another woman came past and said, well, we have to get you to the show because that's why all the 700 people are here. But there's no space for you in front of the bakkie because me and my daughter is already in front. So she said, as you can see, there's already a cake and a tart in front. There's no space. There's no space for a boerewors roll as well. You have to stand on the back of the bakkie. So I was on the back of a bakkie with a blue sequin. So I felt a little bit like, what was that movie? Priscilla, Queen of the Desert.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
And that was your moment there.
So Katlego, there I was on the back of this bakkie with this blue sequin. And I thought, what has happened? Where am I? It feels like the Twilight Zone. I've played piano for 20 years to end up with a blue sequin suit on the back of a bakkie in the middle of the Karoo. So while I was on the bakkie, I wrote this.
And this is the story behind the song that you're about to hear. You can follow at Rocco de Villiers online to see where he's performing. Catch him at the booth this weekend. Here we are. What to wear when you're at the back of a bakkie?
We have the cast from The Women I Am on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. They're dancing for your Friday dance, so don't go anywhere. There's still so much coming up after the break.
Say, 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 say.
Welcome back. It is your Feel Good Breakfast Show. It's a Friday morning. We're about to close down this Feel Good edition with a very, very special dance. And I'm joined by dancer and choreographer Lee Beat, who recently showcased her piece, The Women I Am, at the Youngblood Theatre in Cape Town. Thanks for joining us.
And thank you so much for having me.
This amazing piece of dance work that we're about to see now. But tell me about the show first, the production, The Women I Am.
So The Women I Am, it was inspired by all of our women in the city. You know, everyone has their own tasks, doing their own things. And I just wanted to celebrate women, especially seeing that it is Women's Month. Just kind of a shout out to all of the ladies that are doing their thing and are not really celebrated. So dance just wanted to give back and say thank you to them.
Absolutely. Yeah. So when it comes to choreographing a dance like that, what goes on in your mind as a choreographer, and how do you put it together, especially representing women at such an important time?
Well, I think women are told you shouldn't be doing this and you shouldn't be doing that. And in the dance studio, you have the freedom to really explore all elements of your body without having any kind of judgment placed on you. And that was really just what inspired me to get the choreography going, for us to embrace our bodies, who we are as women, without being apologetic.
Oh, wonderful, wonderful stuff. This is a piece from The Women I Am, yes, presented by Lee Pete and her dancers. So ladies, the stage is yours. We shall vacate.
Let's. Thank you.
We got it all figured out. We said, oh, 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 oh.
Dance there by Lee Pete's crew from The Women That I Am. Wonderful stuff, hey, celebrating women's
lives. The heels, the jackets.
Oh, all of it. Hey, speaking of the wonderful fashion, thank you very much to
Superstars. Gert-Johan
Coetzee. You can check out and shop the look at shopger.com. Oh, and also thank you to Rocco de Villiers. Have a wonderful weekend.
We'll see you on Monday. Get those jeans out there.
Expresso Morning Show, made with love by Clover.
Another feel-good production.